Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Today's transmission is going to be quite a challenge because this news is all so important. I have got to be able to somehow go over all of it. And we've got three amazing guests, one in studio. Lyndon LaRouche is going to be joining us to discuss the moves to begin impeachment of Obama. That's been going on for more than 2 weeks and has gotten basically zero coverage. We are also going to have author of Dishonest Money, Financing the Road to Ruin, Joseph Plummer. Excellent book on the private Federal Reserve. It's a short book, but you can't put it down. Great for newbies out there that don't understand how the New World Order operates, but folks that have researched it a lot as well. You can always learn something new. Excellent book endorsed by G. Edward Griffin, by Joseph Plummer. Available at Infowars.com, I should add, if you want to support us and the author on the online video bookstore there. And Kurt Nemo is going to pop in as well because he's got an article out, Problem, Reaction, Solution, Anonymous Promises to Take Down the Internet. Now, it's come out that some of the main hacker groups that have gotten in trouble are actually working for the feds. No kidding. And what they're doing is they hang out a name like Anonymous, and then good people do stuff under Anonymous name, bad people do things, idiots do things under the name, but that way you can demonize all of hacking and all of online activism under the name and under the larger rubric of Anonymous. And so I want to get him in here to talk about the evidence that a lot of these hacking groups are working for the government and now saying they're going to shut down the internet, which is exactly what Cyber Command said a few years ago. They said they could attack the web themselves. That's how arrogant they are, like we're not reading what generals are saying, as a pretext to then take control of the web. Then we saw Israel and the U.S., that is the interests that run our countries, launching an attack on the web and on infrastructures, but predominantly on the nuclear systems of Iran with the Stuxnet, and then coming out and saying, we need to take over the internet because of Stuxnet to protect it, of course. Of course. And the internet now is the wired infrastructure of the economy, of the world, of communication. So controlling it is paramount in the globalist paradigm, and they want to get everybody addicted to it when it's open and free, and now they're going to try to phase in the end of the internet as we know it. And I'm going to cover that, the end of the internet as we know it, if you let them. Coming up today, Krypton reports, new Samsung TV has built-in HD camera, microphones, face, and speech recognition. Yeah, just like the Kinect of Microsoft that came out a few years ago. Everything is a two-way AI connection system, and it's been like that for a long time with hidden microphones and cameras, and people find them, and it's like, oh, yeah, right. And then you get the actual specs that TiVo, remember 4 years ago, the Super Bowl announced, oh, we've been tracking what you watch. Here's the numbers, and people got all upset, and they said, oh, we don't want to discuss that, never mind. And in places like Pennsylvania, oh, we're watching you at home over your computer. People freaked out. They're like, never mind, we'll stop. We'll stop. They're doing it. And they're getting bureaucrats and corporate chiefs and their minions just prepared to just do it in mass, where so many of them spy on you that it just becomes accepted. And that's why the CIA director came out last week and said, we're watching everything you do in your house. All the new appliances watch you. It's all a declaration of war against freedom by these treasonous, lecherous traitors. So we'll get into that, the latest on the shooting in France, the economy, Iran, Monsanto.
Folks, Iran and the Mideast nuclear mess is already ballooning our gas prices. Whether you're struggling with food costs, which are being blown up by gas costs now, or know that when the Mideast showdown explodes, whatever food supply you have is all you'll get because of huge panic demand. eFoods Direct Family Packs are the answer. Now, the most affordable, best food is saving you up to 50% compared to other poor quality food companies. The new Alex Jones Quick Fix Family Packs save you so much money, the savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. No matter what effect the Mideast crisis or the crashing economy have, you'll have food as delicious tonight as 25 years from now. Order now for 50% savings and free shipping on these affordable family packs. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex.
This is Alex Jones with five good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number one, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number two, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number three, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number four, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number five, a solar power generator provides powerful backup insurance and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365. Hi folks, this is Alex Jones and I want to tell you about the Silver Lungs Generator. Now you can produce pure and endless colloidal silver and deliver the solution directly into the bloodstream by breathing the solution through the lungs. The respiratory system is the first line of defense for airborne pathogens and viruses. The Silver Lungs Generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced nano-silver solutions and also delivers the silver nanoparticles instantly into the bloodstream. With continued legislation threatening the sale of nano-silver products, you can now produce pure and endless colloidal silver with the Silver Lungs Generator. Very easy to follow, step-by-step instructions are provided, making production fast and simple. Go to www.silverlungs.com today and learn more about the breakthrough technology of the Silver Lungs Generator. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
Well, I am fired up and ready to go. And they just opened the gate up and I'm on the field. Thank you so much for joining us on this Thursday, 22nd day of March 2012. Hard to believe we're about to end the third month in 2012 here. And I am predicting we're all still going to be here, at least most of us, after 2012. And I predict the mainstream media, the corporate dinosaur prostitute, Decepticon, New World Order types will claim that I said the world was going to end on 2012. Never said that. I've always had the view it's a hoax, a fraud, a false self-fulfilling prophecy so that people think, oh, it's the end of the world anyways. Why should I get politically involved? Now, I do predict 2012 is going to be tumultuous. And I'm going to be doing some special reports on InfoWars Nightly News in the near future on 2012. In fact, I'm going to mark that down because I keep intending to do that, and I haven't yet. So 2012. Another program note. Last week, I interviewed Billy Corrigan of the Smashing Pumpkins in studio, in the TV studio, and it's ready to air tonight. And I said a few days ago I would air it tonight. There's even some news articles out there saying Alex Jones is going to air this big exclusive Billy Corrigan interview tonight about the New World Order, you name it, the nature of consciousness. He hasn't done something like this ever. He did a talk with the Sex Pistols lead guy a few years ago that's been watched millions of times and been very popular, talking about the Illuminati, New World Order, stuff like that. This is in-depth for over an hour. And this morning, I noticed there were news articles about the interview coming up tonight. And I thought, you know what? This is disrespectful to Billy Corrigan that I did a promo video for Dave Mustaine. And that interview ended up being in hundreds of publications. And you know, he talked about a lot of important issues. I need to do a trailer for the Billy Corrigan interview. So I'm rescheduling it to Monday. Monday. And tonight we will put out a promo trailer for the Billy Corrigan interview. But I will air it Monday. But I always have these incredible guests, incredible breaking news, incredible information, and then never even promote it properly so that it actually gets seen so people understand how important it is. So that is going to happen Monday. So you'll have an extended nightly news Monday. We're going to be back with new shows every day. Monday, we went 8 months with InfoWars Nightly News. I was intending internally to go 2 months and then take a pit stopper hiatus while we tuned things. This is beta testing, deciding what type of news show. Will it be 30 minutes? Will it be an hour? How are we going to set the segments up? What are the graphics going to look like? What's our main thrust going to be? What you've seen is simply the training wheels. And the last 2 weeks, we've just been doing new graphics, working on a big announcement that I'm going to have either today or tomorrow. Well, that is a promotional contest video where we put out the rules and announce, hey, we're hiring a male reporter and a female reporter on top of the great crew we've built, the skeletal genesis of this operation. And now I'm looking to get two more reporters / anchors in here. And so we're about to launch that. I've got a bunch of other stuff coming up next week. So that's why I did this 2-week pit stop that's over this weekend. And I'll be back Monday with the nightly news. And I've decided I'm going to do the nightly news 3 nights a week. And then we'll have Aaron Dykes, Paul Watson, or Rob do it. We're also going to get John Bound to do it. Somebody does a great job with the package reports, special reports you've seen him doing. Very thought-provoking. Really impressed with all the work they're doing. Because I'm trying to move this in the direction of you don't hear or see Alex Jones all the time. And there's a lot of reasons for that. A, it needs to be about the information and not about the cult of personality. B, I need to spend time, at least a few days a week with my family. But C, and this is most important, I'm better when I can cool my afterburners. I'm better when I can pull in and get new tires, get new fuil, get a quick oil change. And because people have seen it, when I've taken off a week before, which I've only done maybe 5-6 times, a solid week off in the 17 years I've been on air, I come back and people are like, wow, what is going on here? And whereas I get so wound up all the time, and I'm thinking about this constantly, that I almost basically spin out of control. And so it's my goal to have, other people at least once a week, and I'll still do the show 6 days a week, so I'll be on myself 5 days a week. But my goal is to have it where once a week we have a guest host on the radio, and twice a week we have one of the other anchors or reporters do the nightly news. And then as I develop more reporters and people, I intend to segue them into doing the nightly news. And then there's other issues as well where I've already got all these TV stations and cable systems and a national cable channel in England that I looked it up has millions of viewers. In the 2 hours we're on every Sunday, I went and looked at the numbers, 250,000, 300,000 viewers in the UK. And that's not giant, but that's big. I can't even handle now the emails and calls from media wanting to pick up the show and wanting to not have to download it off PrisonPlanet.tv. And it's in high quality so they can air it on television. But I've got to then research the systems, the uploading, news file sharing. Will I get satellite? I mean, it's just a big, big enchilada to cook. It's a big nut to crack. It's personnel. It's looking at finances. It's trying to figure out I didn't mean to give you a report here right at the start of the show of what I've been thinking, but I mean, you're seeing a public meeting here. You're being told more than my crew's been told, because I'm constantly thinking about what I want to do, what my plans are. And so here I am telling everybody first, because I'm just codifying here on air decisions I've already made and what we're planning to do. And I want to give you this report too. We couldn't have done any of this if it wasn't for you, the listeners, the activists, the freedom lovers, over the years that have stood with us against mainstream media demonization and government attacks, who've stood with us under incredible COINTELPRO and globalist internet sock puppets attacking us, and globalist Pentagon systems attacking us and trying to lie about us in dirty tricks, and the Cass Sunstein cognitive dissonance model of them posing as alternative media and posing as conspiracy theorists and posing as patriots and savaging us up one side and down the other. It's never upset me, because I know I'm doing the right thing. I know I'm truthful. I know I'm credible. I know I'm for real. Doesn't mean I don't make mistakes, and I'm a human. My work is like dirty rags before the Creator, but my heart is good, and I'm for real. And the idea that Alex Jones is real, the idea that you're real, you know you're a patriot, you know that you love liberty, you know that you love freedom, that basic fact, that basic realization and understanding is what is truly going to change our society in the final equation. That's what it's going to take, is you realizing that you're a leader and that you have power and that you count and that you're valuable and that you know you're good. And so you can take action against the tyrants. You can take action against the globalist. You can take action against tyranny and corruption and oppression everywhere you see it. And you can help people change their tire. And you can educate a police officer, and you can help an old lady across the street, and you cannot get in petty fights with your family because the system has trained everybody through television and culture to do it. You can stick together as a family and work things out. If it's 1 degree a month that you make things better, it doesn't matter. It's that tribal understanding that it's not just me against the world, it's all of us that love freedom against the technocrats, the criminal structures, the corrupt systems. That's what we're talking about here. And it's not buying into the COINTELPRO, Cass Sunstein, White House system, which was going on long before Cass Sunstein. He just wrote public policy papers about, we've got to fund in our funding thousands of operatives to go out and get people in fighting because the mainstream media has no credibility. We've got to pose as anti-establishment to get these people tearing each other apart. And we couldn't have done any of this if you weren't sophisticated enough, when the whole system threw everything they had at us and it boomeranged around and actually helped create a bigger buzz about this radio show. All these attacks were turned into good. We turned it into energy. You turned it into energy. People actually came here and found out what we really do, found out who we really are, no matter how they edited what I said, no matter the camera angles they used to deceive people, no matter the dirty tricks, you know, they've done when I'm at the Texas Capitol or somewhere else with camera angles, or with Michelle Malkin with camera angles claiming I was saying killer, or all the other things that they've done, it's backfired on them because you were sophisticated enough to know what was happening. And I just am horrified to think what the next attacks are going to be like, because these systems haven't worked. But bottom line, the message has been sent. The information is out there. We also couldn't have done this without your prayers. And we couldn't have done it without the AM and FM affiliate owners, managers, program directors who have heard me for years talk about this and have now seen it come true and have had the courage to put me on the air. And then now we have the success of the ratings. I mean, I'm number one in most demographics in Austin, number two in the key demographic of, what is it, 18 to 54 on KLBJ. That's on radio, period. Music, everything. We are in places like Orlando, number one. We're number one in many, many areas. Number one. And that is a example of how popular liberty is. And now I see thousands of other writers and talk show hosts duplicating our research and expanding on it and making it even more powerful. And I know that even if they kill me, The message has now been transmitted, and we've had devastating victories against the globalists. The news is straight ahead.
The abundant resource on Earth? Water. It's essential for sustaining life, but it's not always the most available. When disaster strikes, water quickly vanishes from store shelves, like it did during 9/11, Katrina, Japan, and in Joplin. 3 days without water and your body begins to shut down. Don't risk being without an abundant supply of water when the next disaster hits. Get a FlowJack hand well pump. The affordable FlowJack drops right into almost any well and is easy to install without having to remove the existing pump, giving you immediate access to plenty of cool, clean water. You could risk your family's health on a limited supply of stored water, or you could be prepared with the reliable, affordable FlowJack Backup Hand Pump Kit for only $3.99 complete. See how it works at FlowJack.com, spelled FlowJack.com. Be sure to spell FlowJack.com or call 855-4-FLOWJACK, 855-4-FLOWJACK. That's 855-435-6525. Proudly made in America, FlowJack Hand Well Pumps, peace of mind in a box.
We all know that Berkey Water Purification Systems are the most trusted name in water filtration. As an authorized Berkey dealer for over 6 years and serving thousands of satisfied customers, the Berkey Guy offers amazing specials for Berkey Water Filtration Systems. The Berkey Light Systems include a set of self-sterilizing and recleanable black purification elements that purify water by removing chlorine, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, and parasites to non-detectable levels and remove harmful chemicals such as herbicides and pesticides. Order the Berkey Light System today, complete with two black Berkey elements for only $231, and the Berkey Guy will ship your order free of charge. With the purchase of a Berkey Light, the Berkey Guy is also offering a set of fluoride and arsenic filters for only $39.99. That's over 30% off the retail price. Call the Berkey Guy at 1-877-886-3653. That's 1-877-886-3653. Or order online at GoBerkey.com. That's GoBerkey.com today.
HempUSA.org brings you pure camu berry powder. This revolutionary powder contains 50 times the vitamin C of an orange, mixes with any juice or liquid, has 227 servings per container, and is made from naturally grown camu berries, not chemically produced in a laboratory. Order camu berry powder today. Call 908-691-2608 or visit HempUSA.org and see what our powder, seeds, and oil can do for you.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Your family and loved ones aren't ready for empty grocery store shelves. Will they survive if the system crashed tomorrow? Are you prepared to feed your family when a major crisis occurs? Will they perish from the lack of available food because you procrastinated? Getting self-reliant is the only way to ensure you and your loved ones will make it through the coming hardships. One of the most important survival products that is a must-have is garden food seeds. GetSeeds.net is offering a huge garden in a bag that will give you and your family the food security that it deserves. Our food garden in a bag consists of a whopping 100 packets of the highest quality non-GMO, heirloom vegetable, culinary herbs, and a couple of garden variety of fruit seeds for only $59. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, 100 packets of seeds for only $59. This blowout sale will end soon, so call now to secure your huge garden in a bag that is heat sealed for long-term storage at GetSeeds.net. That's GetSeeds.net or call now at 877-341-GROW. That's 877-341-4769. Don't delay. Call today.
Must be some kind of way out of here, said a joker to the thief.
There's too much confusion.
There's too much confusion.
I can't
get no relief.
Well, let me tell you something. There's not confusion here. Everything that the globalists do in their own documents that have leaked over the years is create confusion in the public. Get everybody following false narratives about Mitt Romney versus Barack Obama. That's a controlled game. That's a controlled sum. That's why they've been shutting Ron Paul out through a long list of frauds. But when all of us stop playing along and get outside this giant Truman Show, this Alice in Wonderland that they've created, and start studying what's going on behind the facade. Listen, you don't have to believe everything I say. I want you to go check it out and find out 9 times out of 10, it's worse than I'm even saying. If I'm guilty of anything, it's holding back sometimes, if you want to be honest. A lot of people say, oh, this guy, he's a fearmonger. That's one of their memes they put out. This couldn't be true. It's true and then some. What I'm trying to get you to do is to go and test the boundaries of what you've been taught and what you believe, and to go see if there's any hidden doorways in your worldview. And I think as soon as you look, you'll find they're not hidden at all. And you're going to open those doorways to a wider world. And then you're going to find more doorways to a wider world. And still more and more. That is the majesty. That is the mystery. That is the magic of life and creativity and the electric creation around us. I mean, spring is such a exhilarating time with all the little flowers and the life and the clear night skies. You can feel it resonating with your soul. And then you go watch television or you go see a football game, and it might be exciting at one level, but it doesn't feed the soul. It doesn't satisfy. It doesn't deliver the goods. We've got more electronics, more entertainment, more carnival distractions than humans have ever had. And in every major study, people are less satisfied. There's more porn. There's more topless bars. There's more sex. There's more drugs. There's more of everything. And people are not satisfied. You know who's satisfied? People that truly do serve humanity. People that truly engage in exploration. Dangerous exploration. Humans are meant to be challenged. And the globalists have created all these artificial avenues. Warfare. That's what some of our best people do, join the military, because they're instinctively seeking the challenge. But it's working for the globalists in the final equation. There's some good done, but overall it's for an evil overall mission. That's why so many join police, because they're looking for adventure and excitement and challenge. And they want to show that they've got it, not to others, but to themselves. The problem is those directing it from on high are slowly but surely twisting that mission. It is the wanderlust. It is the spirit of exploration that empowers humanity. Now, we've got Lyndon LaRouche coming up with some bombshell info on impeachment of Obama and his inside sources. Joseph Plummer, author of Dishonest Money, is going to be joining us for 30 minutes. And Kurt Nemo for about 20 minutes as well on some big news, problem, reaction, solution. Anonymous promises to take down the internet. Of course, the government will have some. Oh, it's Anonymous. It took it down. Now we're going to blame the general public. And people are like, hey, Anonymous does good work. Some people under that name Anonymous, but it's tailor-made to blame the whole when it's completely anonymous. Just like Occupy Wall Street was set up and pushed by globalists, good people showed up because it was a nebulous calling for going after corruption in Wall Street, and then George Soros and the White House could come in and take it over. That failed, so then they, under a Homeland Security sweep, SWAT teamed them nationwide in a single night and started arresting them and now charging them with felonies. Because they couldn't co-opt it. They wanted a plastic revolution, like the ones they've stimulated in the Middle East. But not to bring liberty and freedom, but to bring Al-Qaeda rule. And here it wasn't to bring going after the insiders on Wall Street engaged in corporate crony fraud. It was to give those crony fraud people more power. We'll be back with key news. Stay with us.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
I had tried everything. I'd cut back the amount of food I was eating. I was lifting weights and jogging, but nothing was working. My body was literally starving for minerals and trace elements as well as key vitamins. And as soon as I had that, I immediately could eat half of what I was eating previously and be satisfied. Now, there are hundreds of great products at InfoWarsTeam.com, but I want to point out the three that have helped me lose 37 pounds in just 2 months. Products like Beyond Tangy Tangerine, Pollen Burst, and Rebound. When I started taking the Tangy Tangerine and other products every day, I lost more than 37 pounds in just 2 months. Now that's results. I want to challenge my listeners to go to InfoWarsTeam.com and to order just three of their products, and you will see the changes in the way you look, feel, and in your appetite almost immediately. Start your journey to health and wellness today. InfoWarsTeam.com.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for SurvivalSeedBank.com.
Folks, Iran and the Mideast nuclear mess is already ballooning our gas prices. Whether you're struggling with food costs, which are being blown up by gas costs now, or know that when the Mideast showdown explodes, whatever food supply you have is all you'll get because of huge panic demand, eFoods Direct Family Packs are the answer. Now, the most affordable, best food is saving you up to 50% compared to other poor quality food companies. The new Alex Jones Quick Fix Family Packs save you so much money, the savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. No matter what effect the Mideast crisis or the crashing economy have, you'll have food as delicious tonight as 25 years from now. Order now for 50% savings and free shipping on these affordable family packs. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex.
Leading a frontal assault on the lies of the New World Order, it's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen. You have found it, the front lines of the InfoWar, the tip of the spear. I'm here 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central, 12 noon to 3 p.m. Eastern. And then, of course, we have the nightly news, 7 o'clock. Weeknights at prisonplanet.tv, and we are running in perpetuity a 15-day free trial where you can go sign up for the monthly subscription. It's $5.95 a month. That's, you know, a quarter the cost or less a day of a cup of coffee, and you finance what we're doing. If you like the kind of guests we're having, if you like the fact that we're reaching millions and millions of people every day conservatively, well, I mean, we're reaching like 10 million people a week on YouTube. I always say we reach 15 million people a week. That is a very conservative number. I've got to revise that. I've done some breakdown actuaries. It's a great responsibility. I'm not here bragging. Hey, we reach a lot of people. I'm saying, wow, we're actually having an effect. Every day now, I see articles we break, reports we put out at InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com that end up being picked up by big newspapers, big publications, and more, they're actually saying, as first reported by InfoWars.com. In the old days, they'd never give us credit for anything, but we've become a major news source. And we'd already knocked the door down in many respects 4 or 5 years ago. But I tell you, the Drudge Report, drudgereport.com, the biggest news aggregator in the world, the number one driver of news traffic on the planet, linking to us in the last 5 years and accelerating that because we break more and more news that's pertinent, has really also super energized Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com as the names in hardcore, avant-garde, risky, and by risky, I mean risky to the establishment, information. And that's why it's so important that all of you realize that we're not going to have this free web forever if the globalists keep moving in this direction. So we need to, A, fight to keep the web open and free, freer. It's not totally free now. That's A. And B, use it like it's not going to be here. And those two things go together. It's use it or lose it. And I've got some internet news I've got to get to here in a moment. I haven't even begun getting into all of the news and information. Come on in. I see you guys stacked up there with some breaking news. Let's see what this is. Turkish government goes for gold, seeks to transfer private gold holdings into bank system. Yeah, I saw that. And a bunch of other governments are moving in that direction. Obama's put a joke out saying, if I told you, I'd have to kill you. Yeah, we've got some of that. Sarkozy's now saying visiting hate or terror websites will be punished. Yeah, they're going to use this, these sad deaths over there to take free speech. And I've got to tell you right now, this whole thing has all the hallmarks of a staged event. So now visiting websites that they say are hateful. By the way, they list Infowars.com or PrisonPlanet.com in many European nations as hate. You will be punished for the site you visit. You know, they were watching this guy for years. Turns out he was being controlled by French intelligence. He was allowed to do what he did, bare minimum. They might have just killed some innocent guy up there and thrown him out the window. I mean, who knows? They've been caught doing this before. But now you know by the way they're acting. And boy, he wants to get reelected, doesn't he? And of course, here's the headline, Financial Times, Sarkozy stands to gain most from arrest. No kidding. Remember Obama? Man, if we could just have a new Oklahoma City, I'd get reelected. All those memos advising him. Blow up a bunch of kids. They love to kill kids. I kept telling you, the false flag could come here or in Europe. I'm going to get to that report in a moment. Let me go ahead now and just start getting into the internet news here. New Samsung TVs have built-in HD camera microphones, face and speech recognition. They're basically Kinects that would cost $100,000 for that from any other proprietary system, but cost a couple hundred bucks. They face scan you. They voice print you. They've got cameras all over them. New cars have cameras on the front and the back for your safety. Schools everywhere are admitting they're watching children at home on their laptops. Now, when this first started breaking 4 or 5 years ago, people said, Alex, there's not schools in Pennsylvania and California watching kids on their laptops. I even had the mainstream articles where the schools were admitting it and trying to hide it in plain view, and people would call me and talk show hosts would laugh. Now, as soon as it became a big national story, they're like, well, what's wrong with watching kids at home? You go, well, why did they go from saying it's horrible and denying it to saying, oh, it's good? Because before it was proven to them, they were saying, oh, there's no way that's happening. As soon as it was announced, they're so scared, they immediately make a decision to accept it. It's like play acting. They're playing along. Oh, okay, well, then it's okay. Because it would be too scary to think you're living in a society doing that. See, that's how the split-second thing works. And I've been there with media people saying, I can show you government documents and clips where they're announcing world government out of the financial crisis, and then it's staged. I can show you their admissions and video. They go, that doesn't exist, you're crazy. Oh, sure. I show it and they go, well, okay, let's go get lunch. But wait a minute. Well, that doesn't matter. We're not going to report on that. You know, Nightline was here. And I've gotten literally hundreds of Twitters and emails, and I've seen comments without even looking going, Jones has done it now. He says that the CIA director says our appliances are watching and listening to us. And I actually read his quotes on air. It's in hundreds of publications. And Pete, in fact, cue up that Fox News clip for me on that. Thank you. but still people can't believe it. Yeah, the headline on the video is CIA spying on you through your refrigerator. Now, I called Paul Watson about this last week and I said, do reports on this, please. And he said, well, I got all this other stuff I'm working on. He said, you know, we reported on that 6-7 years ago and again last year, Alex. And I said, I know. And he goes, we got the press releases from Google admitting 6 years ago they're watching everybody over the cameras and microphones and that they're NSA. I know, but now they're admitting the former head of DARPA runs it. Okay, yeah, I'll do a report. Never did. I'm not mad at him, but you know, for us, we're so acclimated because we already know we're telling the truth that when it's admitted, I mention it, and people go, oh, that's crazier than him saying that the plastic lining is an estrogen mimicker and feminizes men. And then hundreds of George Soros-connected groups came out in a meme in organized attack and said, I was insane. And I do talk shows to this day, and they go, you're the crazy guy who thinks that juice boxes make us gay. And I said, what I said was, here's all the government documents, how they chose this type of plastic to feminize men. And by the way, the big part of the report was, give you breast cancer. Give you breast cancer and prostate cancer. You need to be concerned about that. And they're like, shut up, homophobe. And I'm like, listen, it's causing the frogs and fish to be hermaphrodites. This is a planned program. It's running off into the lakes and streams. And they just go, shut up, homophobe. And I'm like, listen, it's not about that. These chemicals are giving you cancer. Shut up, like the Coney guy. Nah, nah. So that's what's going on. And this is the type of invincible ignorance that we deal with. All the new TVs, everything. You won't be able to buy a cell phone that isn't a smartphone. You won't be able to buy a TV or a computer that doesn't track you two-way. And they're wired under federal regulations and global regulations where you cannot deactivate it. When your phone and computer is off, they are designed under global regulations on record to turn on and watch you. And you're like, well, I just will unplug it. You have to unplug it physically. Because not just the computer router, the cable, the power cord, has data over power line. And then I get emails saying, prove it. Hey, if you're too dumb to know about data over power line in place for 20 years, okay, just because you're ignorant, like the guy that came to me in the pizza place 10 years ago and poked me in the back and said, you're a liar about goats that are part spider. He said, I went to biology in the 70s at UT, and I didn't even argue. I said, whatever you want, then just get out of my face. Again, I don't have time to sit here and play games with you. I don't have time to sit here and have people go, oh, that's too extreme. It's 2012. All this is going on. Chemical and biological weapons are added to your food and water on record, and now they are publicly admitting they're doing it because we've been exposing them. Their psychological warfare chiefs have now moved to the model of hiding in plain view. Now, for over a week and a half, it's got to be 2 weeks almost now, I've been reporting on this Petraeus thing, and now it's coming out in the news. I was listening to BBC this morning driving in, and they were on there, and they were doing a show about how they use Kinect to watch cricket players and soccer players to train them better, because it's a body scan, and I knew it was coming, and at the end of the report, I knew it. They said, soon we'll just implant chips in all the players. And I knew that was next in the report, because I know the script. It's repeated. It's a talking point. And I was sitting there driving in the car. My dad was calling me, and I said, I'm not going to answer that right now. I have to wait till the end of the report. And I was waiting, and anybody who listens to BBC, they'll air it again and again today. The answer is get implantable chips. Soon, if you're going to be on the team, you're going to have an implantable chip. See, they phase it in. First, it's Google goggles you're going to wear. You know, and then it's 3D interfaces, and then it's apparatus you wear, and it'll be the cool thing to do. And I've got Department of Defense documents from 1970s saying how they would roll it out as stylish and cool. And for people in prison, and for people with degenerative disorders, and it's all going to sound great. And it would be good if it didn't have Trojan horses built in. So the globalists, in their own words, say they're forcing an artificial evolution. I call it a de-evolution, because all these systems are meant to control. If the globalists do everything they can to dumb us down and poison us, do you think they're going to give us all these technologies that are going to empower us? No. Early on, they let us use a freer internet to get addicted. Now that the wires are all going into place, they're saying, now it's not going to be free. Now you're going to go to jail if you visit the sites we say are hate. and at public schools and universities in the U.S. and worldwide, the software they pay for blocks InfoWars and Prison Planet as hate and hacking. And you never even know it exists. Now, I'm a problem because I've broken through at every level of media. They're not just going to be able to censor me and shut me down. But here it is. NSA boss says agency does not monitor your email. Total lie. They've been caught lying over and over again because in their own DARPA meetings that are public, they admit everything is run through. But see, they've got subgroups like Total Information Awareness that I was on RT the other day. They were saying this new group, it was set up in 2001 by Admiral Poindexter. Then when it got exposed, they moved it to a private group. So it's true. They actually have subcontractors that read your email. That's just like whenever they had HEB TV pieces on the grocery store locally years ago going, we thumb scan you now when you come through and buy your groceries. But don't worry, it's not a image of your finger. It's some zeros and ones. Well, technically, it is zeros and ones that they create an algorithm from, but it is an image of your finger. So it's all these games. And so now the NSA director's in there before Congress, in front of the congressman that thinks that islands will capsize if there's too many troops on them. I'm not kidding. And he says, no, we don't spy on people because it's illegal. Meanwhile, though, they've got the head of the CIA. Remember just 10 years ago, they said the NSA didn't exist. Remember that? I would get calls 15 years ago saying, Alex, there's no such thing as the NSA and Echelon. Quit lying. Even though it was in all the congressional documents, the public said it doesn't exist because you don't do that in America. Now we've got all this happening. NSA boss's agency does not monitor your email. And Easter bunnies are real. Superman's real. Next, you can and Obama loves us. And Holder doesn't want our guns. He just wrote public letters saying totally ban them and brainwash the public. But he's a nice man. You see, when you're not aware of the brainwashing and believe the lie that, oh, it doesn't exist, that's a conspiracy theory, the government's benevolent and loves me, you're just wide open to this. All I'm saying is, open the blinds, look outside in the wider world. You are being manipulated. You are being targeted. And you better start looking into it, because once you do look into it, you're going to find out Alex Jones has been telling you the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but it. Okay? It's just my verbal skills cannot enunciate and cannot orate and cannot transmit to you the full spectrum magnitude of the scientific dictatorship. But you can go read the Wired magazine article with the quotes from the NQTEL CIA Google controlling system. That's who that is. We'll spy on you through your dishwasher. And he goes on in the quotes saying it's transformational. All devices are already having it built in to watch and listen to you. And he went on to say privacy is not what it used to be. You know, just basically just accept it. That they're going to do it. I mean, I've read the quotes on air over and over again. Meanwhile, I still have people thinking I'm making this up. Okay? I mean, here's another Wired magazine article. The NSA is building the country's biggest spy center. Watch what you say. See, that's why Petraeus has come out and said all this. They want you scared. They want those of you that are intellectual and informed, or at least know how to tie your shoes and know this is classical tyranny, to get scared. Well, you better be scared of getting scared. You better be scared of giving in to these guys, because in thousands of their documents, once this electronic panopticon technocratic system's in place, what they're going to do is release bioweapons and say terrorists did it and kill everybody. Oh, yeah, that's why I'm not worried about them killing me. That's why I'll get on air and read public documents that the government is a bunch of narcotic trafficking murderers, because I want my kids to make it and I want their kids and your kids to make it. I'm doing what a man does. When there's no chance for our people, if we don't fight these guys, I'm doing all I can do. It isn't about me selling out to a system that plans on killing everybody. Do you understand that? That plans on getting rid of all of our speech, staging false flag terror attacks, and banning it. Sarkozy's saying you'll be arrested if you visit Infowars.com. Because I know in France, I've confirmed, because Paul Watson's parents live there, when he goes to visit, all the time InfoWars is blocked and listed there. Train stations in England block us, and we're listed as hate. Every time the media is here, they say, are you worried about exposing this stuff's going to cause violence? That's the new meme. That's how they're coming after us. Take us out to break with just a minute of Fox News admitting the systems. I'm going to come back and get into the attack on free speech. Here's that clip from Fox News taking us out to break.
Well, security at home now and questions about whether the CIA could spy on people through their refrigerators. There's this report out from Wired Magazine's National Security blog that says the CIA Director David Petraeus recently spoke about smart technology in our homes, technology that connects a television or an oven to the Internet. It's all supposed to make our lives easier, but Director Petraeus says spies could use that technology to keep an eye on people without their knowledge. Let's take this to the judge. Fox News senior judicial analyst Judge Andrew Napolitano is with us. I mean,
That's enough.
This up.
The full clip is up on Infowars.com. This is a week after we covered it. And I get these emails and things, you know, still not knowing this is going on. And they quite frankly kind of soft pedal on Petraeus, what a great guy he is. Petraeus said, we're using this on you and we're going to use it and you have no Fourth Amendment. Go read the stinking quotes. Petraeus is a piece of New World Order, traitorous, anti-American trash. A little over a year ago, I began to do a lot of research into why, even though I had a pretty good-sized meal, that I was still starving. And my research led me to a well-known fact that most of the soils that we grow our crops on here in the United States and across the industrialized world are almost completely depleted of almost all of the key minerals and trace elements that our bodies need to rebuild themselves, fight off cancer, and be healthy. I then searched out the best vitamin and mineral company out there and discovered Youngevity. The Youngevity products are designed to give you the real nutrition you need, and once you've got that, you don't have to eat as much to be satisfied. I've lost 37 pounds in 2 months, simply getting the vitamins and minerals I need. Check it out for yourself. It's incredible. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
What you're about to hear will help you remember where to find the best water filter products at the best prices on the web. There. Did you hear it? BerkeyShop.com. With the newest Berkey products in stock, the best prices on Berkey products anywhere, fast free shipping, and the most amazing customer service. BerkeyShop.com. Home of all Berkey water filter products like the Big Berkey for producing clean drinking water by removing contaminants, chemicals, heavy metals, and even fluoride. Call 1-888-6-BERKEY to get your Berkey water filter. Perfect for home, travel, camping, or disasters. And BerkeyShop.com is the perfect site to get your Berkey because we're open 24/7 with free shipping and no sales tax. Even celebrities and NFL athletes shop at BerkeyShop.com. Call 1-888-6-BERKEY to order your Berkey products. That's 888-6-BERKEY or go to BerkeyShop.com. 888-6-BERKEY or go to BerkeyShop.com. For everything Berkey, shop BerkeyShop.com.
Hi, I'm Mark Craighead, founder of Crossbreed Holsters. I designed our top-selling holster, the Super Tuck Deluxe, to solve the problems of being poked, pinched, and gouged while carrying concealed. The Super Tuck Deluxe is the most comfortable, most concealable holster on the market today. We offer a 2-week free trial and a lifetime warranty.
Visit us at crossbreedholsters.com. Don't forget, crossbreedholsters.com.
In a coming apart world, you need something to keep it tied together. That something is Atwood Rope, the highest quality rope made in the USA from exotic braids for military, rescue, arborists, shipyards, tow line, or boating. Quality rope at affordable prices you and your customers can depend on. Find a dealer or shop online at atwoodrope.net. Enter promo code RADIO to receive 100 feet of 550 paracord free with purchase. Atwood Rope, working to keep the world tied together.
What's in my stacks of news? Illinois House kills audio recording bill. The Illinois House killed a bill Wednesday that would have allowed citizens to make audio recordings of police officers in public places. Well, it's already on record that there's no perception of privacy in public. That's why the government can record and videotape. So why aren't the police being charged with that? Again, they're misapplying a law that doesn't even cover it. The State House tries to pass a law saying stop putting people in jail for this, and it gets killed. That's like communist China. I mean, this is off the charts. Oh, here's another one. I got a report I want to go over later. All over the United States, they're banning giving food to the homeless, including canned food. They're telling food banks you can't do it anymore. Only the government can do this. Bloomberg's come out and said, no, no more food banking. They want you on government food stamps in the system, period. I mean, Stalin is the only guy that did stuff like this. They're going after farmers everywhere. I mean, folks, we got bad guys running things, and it's bigger than Obama. It's global. And the entire top brass of the military that's not speaking out, they're involved in treason because the UN has announced through its agents, Obama and others, and Secretary of Defense Cohen, Secretary of Defense, it was the old Secretary of Defense, Secretary of Defense Panetta, that they take UN orders. And that is treason. So they've announced the coup. A bill's been introduced to start impeachment. Hadn't got any coverage. They're announcing, hey, we're watching you without warrants, listening to you. Yeah, we're shipping the opium in from Afghanistan. What you going to do about it? That's in the LA Times. That the government was dealing drugs under Fast and Furious. That's been out for over a year. That's been out since last February. We broke it. That whole thing about selling guns and tracking them out of gun shops, that's the ATF released that, hoping to make the story about that, not the drug dealing and all of it. Mafia runs this country. They don't run all the media yet. Here's Sarkozy. Sarkozy, visiting hate and terror websites will be punished. Notice hate, they tie to terror. President Sarkozy addressed has spoken strongly against extremism, which is criticizing big government, but urged his countrymen not to stigmatize Muslims. Yeah, yeah, bring in Muslims at record rates. Again, if they're really saying the Muslims are the terror, no, they're going to use this against everybody. After a 32-hour siege, it resulted in the death. I said they'd probably die yesterday, just like in Spain. Turned out the government did do that. That's even in the Spanish papers. They blow it up. They go kill a few patsies, blow them up in an apartment building. Same thing here. Blow them up, throw his body out the window. Sarkozy has proposed a raft of new anti-terror measures. And he basically went on to say they're going to restrict free speech because it's ideological indoctrination and forced recruitment. And guess what? They've talked about nationalist groups in France that want sovereignty, the ones that actually, and again, I'm not attacking Muslims here, but I'm saying from that position, the groups that actually want to control sovereignty, they're going to get shut down. You got to love how this works. Here it is. Sarkozy stands to gain most from arrest. Financial Times of London analysis. Report, woman warned French police over Toulouse shooter years before killings. And there were the reports that he was in a prison and allowed to escape in Afghanistan and on a watch list. Of course, was he just a useful idiot patsy nut they allowed to do it? That's bare minimum, like the underwear bomber who the U.S. government got on the plane. And again, they're saying he's not connected to any real Al-Qaeda because it's never real. It's some useful idiot who believes the ideology and is basically a copycat. Copycatting ADL, grandson head, Adam Gadon, head of Al-Qaeda, on the news saying he's going to kill everybody, uploaded in U.S. government video format with the U.S. government bug next to the Al-Qaeda bug. The government uploads these things. So you got the Jewish commanders of Al-Qaeda up there commanding this guy. I can't handle it anymore. It's all going to be used to take our speech. And of course, I told you how this case would end. Standard deal. Intelligence on.
This is GCN, the Genesis Communications Radio Network.
When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gussets got it, others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond Gusset Jeans. Made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond Gusset Jeans got it. Others don't.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Marine Le Pen, in all the polls, was set to beat Nicolas Sarkozy in France. They can't have nationalists over there. And so magically, this extremist kills some poor children and paratroopers. Sarkozy says they're going to start arresting people for their speech, banning visiting sites like Infowars.com. That is being reported all across Europe. He's given a speech just hours ago. And, notice that from the socialist bent, we had Dominique Strauss-Kahn 10 points ahead, and he got caught with the prostitute. Turned out that was all fake in hindsight and a total setup, and they admitted French intelligence under Sarkozy was running all of that. This is another intelligence op. I'm going to cover it after Lyndon LaRouche leaves us at the start of the next hour. Kurt Nemo is going to be in studio with us. Wow, that is incredible. Lyndon LaRouche, of course, does not need to really be introduced. He has been a perennial presidential candidate to inject issues. His analysis of the Anglo-American banking cartel has been the most accurate I've seen out there. And other interesting minds like Webster Tarpley have spun out of that group. And I agree with their analysis. I don't always agree with their solutions, but I respect their work. And he's one of the greatest political living minds out there. And he's been, he's also one of the most articulate and sharp people I know, who's approaching 90. Lyndon LaRouche, thank you for joining us, sir. How old are you now?
I will be 90 in September.
Wow, I've never seen Skype this clear. It looks like high-def television, sir. Looks like I can reach through the television. We're about to come back in the official, you know, launch. Some stations don't carry the short segment. But tell us on your radar screen, I know the move to impeach Obama, these executive orders. What are you going to brief us on, sir, on the other side of the break?
I can tell you where we're in the worst crisis in the history of civilization right now, especially in the transatlantic region. But it extends, of course, into the Asian region as well. So we're on the verge of what threatens to be soon World War III, but not just World War III, thermonuclear World War III, and that is what our military leaders, who are responsible ones, are concerned about. They may not be telling this whole story, and that's right on their part not to. I'm more free to tell what the whole story is. But once you start playing around with thermonuclear weapons, like the Ohio-class submarines, which can do that job, it's one of the few capabilities on this planet that can do that kind of job. Every nation, many nations have these capabilities now. But a thermonuclear war actually is one from which civilization could never recover. And therefore, stopping this president, the United States president, and stopping the British, who are the chief perpetrators, Sarkozy is just one of the added features of this. These people are threatening humanity with extinction. And that's what we have to see, and that's what we have to stop.
Well said, Lyndon. With all of this happening, I know you guys have also put out some emergency alerts on the fact that a move towards impeachment has begun. Also, we see wartime executive orders being activated by Obama. All of this leans towards that there could be some type of attempt to stay in office.
It's going to be an attempt to set up a world dictatorship. And this year, and if Obama remains in office, I believe we'll be all the victims of it.
Unbelievable. I've never heard you speak like this, and so much of what you've said, unfortunately, has come true with prophetic accuracy. We're going to go to break. Lyndon LaRouche is our guest. LaRouche, LaRouchePack.com, LaRouchePub.com are two of the websites. And we're going to break down thermal nuclear war, the attempt to set up a world dictatorship through the banking cartel with Lyndon LaRouche in the next hour. And then we're going to get into all these other events that are taking place. Stay with us. I'm Alex Jones with PrisonPlanet.tv, where we're streaming video of this syndicated radio transmission. Stay with us. We'll be right back. We're also on XM Channel 166. A little over a year ago, I began to do a lot of research into why, even though I had a pretty good-sized meal, that I was still starving. And my research led me to a well-known fact that most of the soils that we grow our crops on here in the United States and across the industrialized world are almost completely depleted of almost all of the key minerals and trace elements that our bodies need to rebuild themselves, fight off cancer, and be healthy. I then searched out the best vitamin and mineral company out there and discovered Youngevity. The Youngevity products are designed to give you the real nutrition you need, and once you've got that, you don't have to eat as much to be satisfied. I've lost 37 pounds in 2 months, simply getting the vitamins and minerals I need. Check it out for yourself. It's incredible. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
This is Alex Jones with 5 good reasons you should consider buying a solar power generator. Number 1, new climate legislation could easily double or triple your electric bill. Number 2, our new energy czar wants to control how much power your electric company allows you to have. It's true. Total government control of electricity in the name of smart grid technology is coming. Number 3, in some areas of the country, the power grid is dangerously overloaded. And now, new socialist legislation is only compounding the problem. Number 4, dangerous weather is always a threat to local grids. Every year, thousands of families lose their power from weather-related outages. Number 5, a solar power generator provides powerful backup insurance and peace of mind. Folks, I really believe in the solar power generators offered by Solutions from Science, one of my oldest sponsors. You can get more information at www.mysolarbackup.com. That's mysolarbackup.com. Remember, the government doesn't own the sun, so go to mysolarbackup.com or call 1-877-327-0365.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Cowbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calvin on the web at 5starsoap.com.
From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
That's right. We are in the Republic of the United States. It's been captured by Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan, the big private megabanks out of Europe that have created a black hole of over $1,000 trillion that they have induced, they paid off traitor politicians in Europe, England, and the United States to sign us onto. Even The Economist magazine, the Financial Times of London, admit that it's a banker coup over Europe and that the debt is their fraudulent debt. But then they say that's a good thing because they're technocrats and they know best. So now, open world government by and for private banks is admitted. Our president is telling Congress that he can launch wars without congressional approval, and that he can get that authority from NATO, itself an Anglo-American banking front. All of this is happening. It's all out in the open now. And I've, from so many historians that I've talked to, people like Lyndon LaRouche and countless others, they've said that when the system uncloaks itself, that means it's getting ready to launch a new war, and that they're unfreezing society and that we're going into a rapid period of change. The question is, what does that change mean? Now, Lynn and LaRouche has put out alerts at LaRouchePAC.com, breaking down the fact one of the few media outlets that covered 2 weeks ago that legislation had been introduced that if Obama launches wars without congressional approval, that impeachment would be triggered because it violates Article 1, Section 8, Clause 11. They've also put out reports that we've confirmed, obviously, that Obama has activated nuclear war COG doctrine that can only be used when we're under major attack in peacetime to take control of the economy. So a major war footing is being prepared. All of this happening while we see the activity around Iran, proxy wars in Syria. Lynn and LaRouche, who a former CIA director called the best private intelligence in the world, a former head of the National Security Council, said something similar, joins us. He has incredible sources in government to be able to tell us exactly where we are currently geopolitically. Lynn and LaRouche, thank you for joining us. You've got the floor. Please brief us on where the world stands right now.
We're on the verge in the near future of a threatened thermonuclear war. It would be launched essentially by the United States under Obama, but actually the direction would come from the British, because Obama's not really that bright. He's simply a stooge for the British, essentially. And that's why things happen the way they do. Now, what the threat is, the only war that's threatened, is to induce the United States, under the reign of Obama, as a British stooge, to launch a thermonuclear war with Russia, China, India, and other countries, largely in the Asia region. The intention is to do it soon. It was actually the intention to do this last year, shortly after the killing of Libya's president, Gaddafi. But our people, our patriots, and people in some other countries combined forces to postpone the intention to launch that war. The war is still being pushed. It's not been brought through. And Russia and China and India are taking steps to try to minimize this problem. But the danger here is very few people understand it. I know that our leading military figures do understand it, but they don't want to say it publicly because the effect would be to panic people. Because they're government. I am not government, even though I have my ties into our government, which there. But I can say it. What you're looking at, one day, it could possibly be the Israeli launching of an attack on Iran could start it, because a set of alliances would then go clicking into action, and you would very soon be at the threat of a thermonuclear war. Now, the characteristic of a thermonuclear war, when full-scale weapons, say the Ohio-class submarines in the Pacific or the south region of waters, unleashes their full-scale attack of their capacity, their fire capacity, then Russia and China in particular, the signal of that launch has occurred from the hands of Britain and the United States, then they'll take an action. Now, the result of that, which is very few people understand, is that when you unleash a thermonuclear war, you have to go all the way. Your objective is such, because of the effects of thermonuclear weapon systems, you go for a kill, a total kill with the first shot, with as much as you've got. But immediately, Russia, for example, in this case, or China, would have to immediately respond with their full thermonuclear kill capability. Now, this kind of process leads into a threatened extermination of the human species. What does it do? Well, that depth of explosion will have side effects which will make the planet essentially uninhabitable. Foodstuffs will essentially disappear because the source of them will be crippled. And it could be the extinction of the human species. That's how far it can go. Now, those who are responsible in our military circles, know this, and I don't ask them to say it. I can say it. The facts are there, and I would hope people just look in the direction to recognize. The only way I can see that now we can have an assured avoidance of a thermonuclear war this year or very soon afterward, more likely this year, would be to remove Obama from office on grounds of his mental incompetence. And he is mentally incompetent. The evidence is there. Remove him from office. And that would mean that our government would no longer be under the compulsion of a British agent, Obama, to launch this war. And without the United States' participation in such a thermonuclear launch, which no other nation really has, then you cannot have this war. But and that's the only solution.
All right, Lyndon, if we have new listeners out there or people who are not informed, the BBC and others reported in December that the Chinese president said prepare for war with the United States because the United States was moving its main task forces into that area of the Pacific and also into Australia. And so I just want to back up everything you're saying. The former head of the Mossad that Netanyahu basically dismissed last year has said it would be a catastrophe and would probably lead to a major multi-theater war. Russia has now, as you know, you said months ago, but now it was admitted yesterday, not just sent in missile ships with nukes to dock there in the Mediterranean at ports in Syria, but they've sent in special forces. We also have India that's normally at odds with China lining up in the last 2 months. This has gotten really no attention here in the U.S. It's all over the Asian and European news, has lined up with China. Pakistan has even gotten closer to China and Russia. And, of course, Pakistan had big problems with Russia. Russia is deploying their mobile launchers, openly saying that this could lead to nuclear war. We saw Cheney launch the 888 attack into Georgia, and they were landing NATO troops until the Russians sent in nukes and went on TV. Their chairman of Joint Chiefs said, we're preparing to launch nuclear weapons at theater forces, and the United States pulled out then. It shows a level of insane brinksmanship by the Anglo-American elite, and I see Admiral Mullen and Fox Fallon before him all saying, don't do it, holding him back. Now they've put Dempsey in, who military officers I've talked to high level say is someone who will do whatever he's told and is not too intelligent. I know you have high-level sources. How close is this now? Because I see Netanyahu saying looks like he's going to get the green light here pretty soon.
Well, this all depends on Obama. And the dumb Americans who continue to support Obama, and unfortunately we don't have anything on the Republican side. We have Republicans who could be qualified to replace Obama, but they're not running right now, unfortunately. And we have some Democrats who also could do the right job, but they are not running, or they're just keeping behind the scenes. But the point is, unless we remove Obama from office very soon, I don't see that there's much possibility of avoiding a thermonuclear war. There probably are options, but they're not clearly defined options. There are too many catches in the whole process.
Sir, my question is, and I want you to elaborate on your deep understanding of this and your prediction of it coming to this head, what does the elite think they're going to do if they start a nuclear war and their first strike intending to knock out all the forces of Russia and China? They'll never get them all.
Well, the point is, the people who are called elites, most of them have just been dumped to the rank of bums. Most of the people who are involved, for example, Wall Street, the entire shebang is bankrupt. The whole U.S. system is bankrupt. You can't save it in its present form. The only thing you can do is you can go through a reform. And reform means cancel most of this debt, which is not worth anything, never will be worth anything, and go through first Glass-Steagall. If you don't go through Glass-Steagall in the United States and other nations, as in Europe, are thinking in the same direction, if you don't cancel the gambling money and go back to saying that money, which is legally money under our system, under our Constitution, yes, we can defend that. We will defend it. But that money, which is gambling money, is not going to be defended under Glass-Steagall, as Franklin Roosevelt determined.
All right, stay there, sir. We've got to go to break. I want to come back and get more into this gambling money. And for new listeners, the bankers created over $1,000 trillion in garbage. They had it certified as real. That's the debt now hanging over us. So they hold us hostage and have us sign ourselves over to pay off their debt, which is fraudulent and is not our debt. So he's saying, write it off, get rid of it. Ron Paul says that. It's us or them. We'll be right back. These madmen want to start a giant war. They admit that.
Folks, Iran and the Mideast nuclear mess is already ballooning our gas prices. Whether you're struggling with food costs, which are being blown up by gas costs now, or know that when the Mideast showdown explodes, whatever food supply you have is all you'll get because of huge panic demand. eFoods Direct Family Packs are the answer. Now, the most affordable, best food is saving you up to 50% compared to other poor quality food companies. The new Alex Jones Quick Fix Family Packs save you so much money, the savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. No matter what effect the Mideast crisis or the crashing economy have, you'll have food as delicious tonight as 25 years from now. Order now for 50% savings and free shipping on these affordable family packs. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex.
That's the sound of your door being kicked in by an intruder with a single kick. That's the sound of the same door now protected by the Door Sentinel at MySafeDoor.com. Go to MySafeDoor.com right now and watch the amazing video. At MySafeDoor.com, you'll learn how to turn your home into a fortress with the Door Sentinel. 16 kicks later, and the Door Sentinel is still holding strong. MySafeDoor.com. That's MySafeDoor.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
That's what it sounds like when a burglar kicks in the door of a dark house that looks like no one is home. Don't let your home be the next target. Make it look like someone is home watching television with Fake TV. Fake TV is a small electronic device that makes the same light as a real television. So from outside, it looks like someone is home watching TV. Fake TV plugs in just like a lamp on a timer, but is far more convincing to burglars. Fake TV deters burglars, costs far less than an alarm, and is highly recommended by numerous police departments. Use it anytime you're away from home. To order your Fake TV for only $34.95, go to FakeTV.com. Or call 1-877-5-FAKE-TV. Each additional Fake TV is only $29.95. So get one for you and one for a loved one for safety, security, and peace of mind for both of you. Call 877-5-FAKE-TV or go to FakeTV.com. FakeTV.com, the burglar deterrent.
Are you having trouble paying your mortgage? Maybe your mortgage loan is upside down or in foreclosure. Maybe the bank already foreclosed on you. Don't sit around being a victim of bank fraud. Fight back. We have the tools to help you fight back. Here's how. Go to InspectorAudit.com and click on the GCN radio special. Order a summary audit. Find the real truth about your loan.
Maybe like me, you'll find your bank loan was paid off already. Maybe, like me, you'll find your bank defrauded you at the closing. And maybe, like me, you will go after them.
Did you know 78% of home loans in the last 10 years violated consumer credit laws? We should not let the banks get away with this fraud. Go to InspectorAudit.com and click on the GCN radio special. Order a summary audit today and find the truth about your mortgage loan. That's InspectorAudit.com or call 855-373-4948. That's 1-855-373-4948.
I was a highwayman, along the coach roads I did ride, with sword and pistol by my side.
Lena LaRouche is our guest for the rest of the hour. Joining us via video, Skype, from the East Coast. And let me tell you, I have never seen Skype look this good. It looks like high-def television. If you're listening on the radio, you can also go to prisonplanet.tv and watch Mr. LaRouche right there from his research center. Sir, when you first got on in that short little segment, you said they're attempting to establish, and I want you to go over this in your own words, a global dictatorship. That's what PNAC, of course, called for. And speak to that and the madness of these people. I understand that they are inbred, they're entitled, many of them are addled by decadence. And I see other elites actually warning of this at a record level. You're not the only one saying this. There are people in the system, as you know. So speak to their goals. Speak to how they think they'll execute this final takeover. And then speak to what some of your inside sources are telling you. They've got to be horrified.
Well, the fact of the matter is we have only one real problem that is a central problem. That's called the British Empire. Now, the British Empire still exists. It's essentially not, it's a monarchy, yes, but the real character of the British Empire is it's a monetarist system. It's an evolution from the original Roman Empire, from the Byzantine Empire, which collapsed, from the Crusader system, which also collapsed. And now this was created as the new Venetian system in its time, which became the British Empire. But the essence of this thing is a monetarist system. And the capital of the monetarist system in the world today largely is a result of the corruption of the United States and our destruction of our own constitution, essentially. The British Empire does really act as the center of the control over this planet.
Sure, it's a British Empire model of crony capitalist, insider, money changer manipulation. It's not capitalism, it's gangsterism.
Well, it is, but what it is actually is it's evil. It's like the Roman Empire. And we've got a president of the United States who thinks like one of the Roman emperors. But the thing is the system, which this process has tried to control, has reached the point that as wars have gone on, the methods of killing in warfare have been improved. We've now reached the stage that if you want to conduct a serious war on a global scale, you have to use the available weapons, which are thermonuclear weapons. So we have a small group of people, most of Wall Street, they're clowns, they're not really serious people. But they're all tied to this British monarchical system, which is a monetary system, which and not all the people are not in on it. It's a very small number. But they are controlling the world. So now here's what we have. We've reached a point. The existing system. We came out of World War II with a victory. Truman was a disaster. And we began to go down. Eisenhower was fairly good in terms of defending on all issues and saved us. Kennedy did an excellent job as president. But they killed him. And then they killed his brother. Now, the result of killing both Kennedy and his brothers, number one, we got World War II, or rather, not just World War II, but we got the breakdown system of the Indochina War. It would never have happened if Jack Kennedy had not been assassinated.
Vietnam, yes.
And that went on for about 10 years, when you take the whole effect of the Indochina War. The result was that everyone was scared. Because the cover-up of the assassination of Kennedy, who did it, scared everybody. Then we got into a system of more wars. For example, more British wars, wars in Asia. And we had this buildup of a permanent system of warfare.
And now they've run out of people to conquer. They've run up to China. They've run up to Pakistan. They've run up to Russia. And the Russians and Chinese aren't going to back off.
No, but Russia is the key figure in this thing because Russia has the intellectual military outlook, which is very crucial in this kind of thing. Russia is really a leading space science nation. And we're going into space science. Mankind is, if we survive this nonsense, we're going to. But the problem, we are now at that point. The British Empire is doomed. It can no longer function on this planet in the way it has functioned. It can only function by destroying almost everybody else or getting them to destroy each other. So that's the situation we face. And many of us know this. We know the facts. But there are reasons why various people don't talk about it, like our official military leaders who do know this. But they don't want to go through all the details. There are good reasons for that. I can speak freely.
Stay there. We got a long segment coming up. Let's look at it from their perspective, though, how they think they'll play us off against each other in a nuclear war, that type of divide and conquer madness. This isn't like it's two pygmy tribes are playing off against each other.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Folks, Iran and the Mideast nuclear mess is already ballooning our gas prices. Whether you're struggling with food costs, which are being blown up by gas costs now, or know that when the Mideast showdown explodes, whatever food supply you have is all you'll get because of huge panic demand. eFoods Direct Family Packs are the answer. Now, the most affordable, best food is saving you up to 50% compared to other poor quality food companies. The new Alex Jones Quick Fix Family Packs save you so much money, the savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. No matter what effect the Mideast crisis or the crashing economy have, you'll have food as delicious tonight as 25 years from now. Order now for 50% savings and free shipping on these affordable family packs. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Calbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. A little over a year ago, I began to do a lot of research into why, even if I had a pretty good-sized meal, that I was still starving. And my research led me to a well-known fact that most of the soils that we grow our crops on here in the United States and across the industrialized world are almost completely depleted of almost all of the key minerals and trace elements that our bodies need to rebuild themselves, fight off cancer, and be healthy. I then searched out the best vitamin and mineral company out there and discovered Youngevity. The Youngevity products are designed to give you the real nutrition you need, and once you've got that, you don't have to eat as much to be satisfied. I've lost 37 pounds in 2 months, simply getting the vitamins and minerals I need. Check it out for yourself. It's incredible. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
I have sworn upon the altar of God eternal hostility against every form of tyranny over the mind of man. Thomas Jefferson. It's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
All right, for the balance of the hour, we're talking to one of the greatest living political analysts, and that's Lennon LaRouge. And he looks like he's about 75. He's about to be 90 here in a few months. Joining us via Skype connection, broadcasting out on channel 166 XM, over 110 AM and FM affiliates now. And, of course, we're number one when it comes to the audio streams at InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.tv, and the number one political podcast as well. You can sign up for that free podcast in the listen section there on the tabs at InfoWars.com. Now, just pointing something out here, just of this show, how popular it is. Liberty is popular. Freedom is popular. Not having wars is popular. Most of the brass, even current, have said don't have war. We saw a big Washington Post page size ad last weekend, and it ran the weekend before that, with all these former top generals saying do not attack Iran. You've got most of the Israeli leadership saying don't do it. But then there's this controlled media here in the U.S. acting like you're a traitor to America or that you hate Israel if you don't want this attack on Iran. It just goes from bad to worse. And we have the West driving Pakistan in the arms of China. We've got all these preparations. And when Lyndon LaRouche talks about Wall Street being bums, they have been so insulated like Caligula or Nero with unlimited power and fraud that they've gotten delusional. As Bernie Madoff said, he said, look, I'm just doing what everybody else does. And that's true. And I'm not saying he's a good guy. He just wasn't as insider as others. He was the creator of the NASDAQ. I mean, he was upper echelon. But I remember a few weeks ago, a top executive at Goldman Sachs, Greg Smith, and you know, he was one of their top managers slash presidents. He came out and said, they call people scum. They call them idiots. They talk about ripping them off. They call them Muppets. This is basically a criminal enterprise. And he said, I can't be part of this anymore. And we've had another managing director, Naomi Prinz, who left 9 years ago. She's wrote books about how all this was going to happen. They knew all this. They set in motion something that they knew would be too big to fail or it would destroy the whole economy. But it's so big, it is destroying it. They're the fraudsters. They've conquered Europe through fraud. All they're having is success, waving nuclear weapons around. But Russia is saying, we're not going to go along with this. And I get emails from people saying, you're for Russia. You're a traitor. Folks, my family came over here on the Mayflower. I know Lyndon LaRouche's family goes way back to the start of this country and Quakers. I'm an American as it gets. It's not pro-America to let a bunch of foreign megabanks run us into the ground and start giant wars that could lead, most analysts say, Lyndon LaRouche isn't fear-mongering here. Many analysts are saying this could easily lead to World War III. Google it. The top brass keeps saying, don't do it, don't do it, don't do it. And the bankers, who are so crazy, you've seen the emails from Goldman Sachs, you know, going, oh, let's sell some bleeping you-know-what to our customers, ripping old ladies off. They are, I've been around some of these Wall Street guys, a guy that was high level in it, worked with George Soros' son, was Max Keiser, and he said that they saw the clients as scum, and they told him, if you don't have a bunch of lawsuits against you for stealing, you're not doing your job. Now get in there and steal. These are people who run the aircraft carriers, the spy satellites. They run America. You look at it, they call the shots, and where do they come out of? The city of London within London. And they're dangerous. They're hubris-filled. They're mad dogs. I wouldn't be surprised if they don't make their horses consolant like Caligula. This has happened before. What do we do, Lyndon LaRouche, with the madness of these people and their crazy puppet who's on vacation half the month and you know, running around guzzling alcohol on television every day? What do we do about a mad imperial elite?
You got two things. One thing, you have to have people with guts. Number two, we do have solutions that are available to us if we want to choose them, which means you have to mobilize the American people to recognize not what's wrong. That's important to consider. But when you see how wrong it is, you have to say, wait a minute, what then is right? Now, we could solve this problem if we could get the right person in as president during these months right now. First of all, Glass-Steagall, kill off the speculation. Yes, they're going to go bankrupt, but they already are bankrupt. So you're not taking anything away from them that they have, that's theirs. They've been taking it from you. So what you have to do, you have to get Glass-Steagall first. That has to be done almost immediately. That would stop the bleeding. But it wouldn't solve the problem. We have to go to another step. We have to tell Andrew Jackson made a terrible mistake when he canceled the original system, constitutional system of banking of the United States. And if we go back to that kind of system today, which is by a declaration of government,
But he was afraid it would be taken over by private interest. But instead, we got the thing that's even worse. We got a foreign central bank.
Oh, he was. No, Jackson was a part of the international interest ripping us off.
Really?
Yeah, he was. Yeah, you take his successor and you took it, the guy who really created him, the British spy, who did more of the dirty work against the United States in those early days than anyone else. But so that you had a ripoff of the United States, the principles of Alexander Hamilton on banking, on national banking, that principle on federal credit, that principle applied now to supplement Glass-Steagall would in itself and by itself lead to a cessation of this inflation.
And Lincoln did that, so did Kennedy, started it.
That's right. And when they killed Kennedy and got by with it and then killed his brother, Bob, and brought in you-know-whom, we started on the road all the way down. We've been going sliding down ever since. And therefore, if we would return to those principles which are our Constitution, or the actual Constitution, our actual intention, and would do it today or start doing it today in terms of getting these bums who are not qualified for president, you can't do this kind of job. Get them all out of the
But that's common sense to get Glass-Steagall back in place. They're not even really discussing it. A few Congress people have tried, and then they've gotten run out of office like Dennis Kucinich. Let me ask you this, because you put out alerts over at LaRouchePack.com and in your executive alert system that folks can sign up for online that's indispensable. Lyndon LaRouche, again, is our guest. Why are they racing to tell Congress they don't control war anymore, which is obvious treason? Why are they openly announcing to everybody that Obama is activating a nationalization of the economy, which isn't even nationalization because foreign banks are running it, so it's a foreign corporate takeover, receivership, like the austerity we see in Europe. We're going under that same system. What is their plan? Why are they moving all of this into high gear?
They want to eliminate the memory of the United States. And we don't have people so far who've had the guts and the position to throw Obama out of office. If Obama is not thrown out of office, you better kiss the United States goodbye where you still have the chance.
Wow. So let me be clear, because I know some of the same interests are behind Romney that are behind him. And more now, Romney is the presumptive person there.
He doesn't figure as very important, except as a nuisance in my record.
Okay, so you're saying they're going to give it to Obama if
Obama, they don't care. What they want to do is destroy the United States. If they destroy the United States, then the only obstacles to destruction of the planet lie in Russia, China, India, and so forth, which are major powers in their own right. But if the United States goes, and we're about to go, if the dictatorship, the fascist dictatorship, by this president we have now, if that's allowed to continue, you're not going to have a United States. You're probably not going to have a world.
Well, I think you just said it. You put your finger on it, and I want you to elaborate, please, sir. They have the head of the CIA come out and say, yeah, we're spying on you without warrants, 2 weeks ago, week and a half ago. Right. We have government openly announcing that we're run by foreign powers and the Congress is vestigial or ceremonial, openly. We have just a flaunting of corruption now, banning protests, arresting people for filming. I mean, the system has put the message out, drive them into submission. And you're saying that's to fully break us and make a clean break with freedom.
This is like Adolf Hitler. You go into the picture of how Adolf Hitler came to power. He was treated originally as a joke by most Germans until he took his measures and started assassinating people and putting them in prisons. And then that took over, and he was run by the British at that time. Hitler was a British creation.
I want you to elaborate, because people think that's a joke. That's why the deputy Führer flew over with a treaty, parachuted out, they locked him up for life, and those documents have come out that they set him up in intelligence. He thought he was going to have an alliance with England, a deal to go into France. They would then team up and take out the Russians, and this is why he wouldn't bomb the British cities. He kept saying, we have a deal. The king was a Nazi. He had to advocate. See, people don't know this history. Please elaborate on that.
Well, just take the case of the guy who created Hitler by saving him from bankruptcy, Prescott Bush, the father of George H.W. Bush and the grandfather of the George W. Bush. These people, I don't think Prescott Bush was clever. I don't think that George H.W. Bush was particularly intelligent. That was the irony of putting him in charge of the CIA was a very bad joke against the human species. And the drunken son, the dope addict, as a president for 2 terms, it was not much help either. So we do have these inside jobs whose function is not to lead the world, but whose function is to make a mess of everything that should be done.
Is that why Nixon wasn't a good guy overall, but they went after him to weaken the idea of a real president?
No, he wasn't a real president. What you take the case, you say, we understand why the oligarchy ordered the assassination of John F. Kennedy. One of the reasons was to prevent him from stopping us from going into long wars in Asia. But then why did they kill Bobby, his brother, later? Well, Robert Kennedy, was about to win the Democratic nomination for president. And by killing him, they cleared the way for Nixon. And Nixon was simply a dumb bunny, bad news.
No, I know that, but why did they then set him up?
They set him up. They set him up because they wanted to get, look what you got. You got, after that, with a little adjustment, you got Carter. Carter was the living joke of American history.
And he had the Trilateral crew in there, total New World Order agents. Okay, so this oligarchy really thinks, because that's their plan, they're even selling, oh, nuclear wars are doable now. I see that in defense publications. Let's have a nuclear war. I mean, cook some hot dogs, you know, on it.
Nuclear war is not on the table anymore. Thermonuclear war. And people talk about nuclear war. We're talking about thermonuclear war.
You're right, thermal, excuse me, much more powerful.
Yeah, it's not only that, it's qualitative. You're talking to a completely different kind of universal chemistry. I mean, it can be understood in general. And we can go to matter, antimatter systems. But before going to antimatter systems, we're now at the point of thermonuclear weapons. And the thermonuclear weapon capability, which is represented best in terms of best quantity, best ability, is by one, is by the Ohio class systems, submarine systems. But if you start using that, remember, if you're trying to put Russia and China and India against the United States in particular, what are you setting up? These are thermonuclear powers, which means that the one who wants to start the war as a thermonuclear talk is going to go throw everything they can at a first shot at the targeted nations. And in a couple of seconds later, then Russia, China, and India are going to know that that's happened in their direction, and they're going to return the favor. Now, what is the planet going to look like after you get that kind of thermonuclear warfare exchange going on? You're not going to have food, because you're going to be killing off the means on which, and you're going to create weather conditions. So just that simple set of exchanges.
But they're willing to do it because they have a fantasy of reducing the population and then emerging from their bunkers a few years later.
It's worse. It's worse. What they're doing now, the British are operating, and it's the British. It's the British monarchy is the center of this, nobody else. Obama's simply a British puppet anyway. But the British monarchy has said they think of themselves as an empire. They think of themselves as an empire in the tradition of the Roman Empire. It's called the oligarchical system. And this group is now operating on the basis that they are dead. If they try to function on a normal basis, they're finished. There's no chance for them. So how are they going to survive? If they can destroy the United States, destroy Russia, China, and so forth, without getting too much damage done to themselves, they can regain their empire. Otherwise, they don't give a damn. And the British monarchy doesn't care who lives or dies. It just cares on one thing, that there will never be a ruling force on this planet to take the role away from the British Empire.
Well, have you also noticed that Petraeus and others are getting all these foreign knighthoods, that it's in the Constitution, that that's illegal? They're entering an agreement and being part of an organization of a foreign government. They're just flaunting the usurpation of our country, I guess trying to set the legal precedent by possessing us. Possession is nine-tenths of the law.
Well, you look at the Bush family, George H.W. Bush. He was one of the first to get one of these nice appointments as a British subject. And he went on to become president of the United States. Who's working for whom?
Well, it's incredible. People don't know that you get this patronage. You get houses, money, all sorts of stuff with that. I mean, it's an open payoff.
This is the way the system works. George Bush, H.W. Bush, is really nothing. I mean, as a man, he's nothing in terms of the standard of a leader of a nation. He's a wimpy, old wimpy George. Huh? But what happens, these puppets like George H.W. Bush and his silly son, they get made figures. They're made objects of worship in the U.S. political system. And therefore the prestige that is awarded to them, which isn't worth anything really, then becomes a lever to cause awe among the unsuspecting citizens who don't know what the devil is going on here, because nobody's telling them to speak of.
It's truly disgusting. I want to give you the floor in the final 6-minute segment coming up after the break. Quickly, sir, tell us what you want to talk about when we come back.
Just about what the solution is.
All right, we'll talk about solution on the other side. And do you support this move to try to start the impeachment of Obama? Maybe we can ask you ideas of... I agree, you know, the figurehead, getting rid of this puppet, that would be a good symbol of the world, Glass-Steagall, all of it. How do we turn the tide against this madness? We'll be right back. Stay with us.
Folks, Iran and the Mideast nuclear mess is already ballooning our gas prices. Whether you're struggling with food costs, which are being blown up by gas costs now, or know that when the Mideast showdown explodes, whatever food supply you have is all you'll get because of huge panic demand. eFoods Direct Family Packs are the answer. Now, the most affordable, best food is saving you up to 50% compared to other poor quality food companies. The new Alex Jones Quick Fix Family Packs save you so much money, the savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. No matter what effect the Mideast crisis or the crashing economy have, you'll have food as delicious tonight as 25 years from now. Order now for 50% savings and free shipping on these affordable family packs. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex.
What is the most abundant resource on Earth? Water. It's essential for sustaining life, but it's not always the most available. When disaster strikes, water quickly vanishes from store shelves, like it did during 9/11, Katrina, Japan, and in Joplin. 3 days without water and your body begins to shut down. Don't risk being without an abundant supply of water when the next disaster hits. Get a FlowJack hand well pump. The affordable FlowJack drops right into almost any well and is easy to install without having to remove the existing pump, giving you immediate access to plenty of cool, clean water. You could risk your family's health on a limited supply of stored water, or you could be prepared with the reliable, affordable FlowJack backup hand pump kit for only $3.99 complete. See how it works at FlowJack.com, spelled FlowJack.com. Be sure to spell FlowJack.com or call 855-4-FLOWJACK, 855-4-FLOWJACK. That's 855-435-6525. Proudly made in America, FlowJack hand well pumps, peace of mind in a box.
Healthy soils grow healthy plants. So before you plant your survival garden this year, is your soil healthy? Maximize your crisis garden soil with EM1 from Terraganics. EM1 organic soil conditioner, fertilizer amendment, and compost accelerant provides healthier gardens and faster, efficient garden composting. EM1 from Terraganics.com quickly improves soil structure by increasing nutrient availability and converting organic matter into soil humus. This improves seed germination and root growth, improves plant quality, size, color, flavor, nutrient nutrient value of fruits and vegetables and improves shelf life. And when rain is not in the forecast, no worries. EM1 improves moisture retention in soils, helping reduce drought stress. Just like you prepare all else, prepare your crisis garden for maximum yields with EM1 from Terraganics.com. Order now at TerraGanix.com or call toll-free 866-369-3678. That's 866-369-3678. Terraganics. Life's getting better.
Federal agents, we are armed!
It's our final segment with Lennon LaRouche of LaRouchePack.com. I really appreciate him joining us once a month or so with his commentary. And unfortunately, I have to agree with everything he's saying. I want to talk a little bit about how we do hopefully get rid of this globalist puppet, Obama. But there's a giant campaign. They're talking about having criminal charges against Limbaugh for making fun of somebody who wanted thousands of dollars of condoms. But meanwhile, Robert De Niro can make fun of anybody he wants, including presidential candidates' wives. And they're trying to get him off the air. I know some behind-the-scenes stuff and affiliates that we're on that also have Limbaugh. We've never seen such an attack. And I agree with this article out of the Associated Press, radio campaign, next step against Rush Limbaugh. And it goes on to break down that it is an attempt to shut down free speech. And we have Sarkozy saying, visiting hate sites, and my site gets listed as hate. I've seen Lennon LaRouche demonized by the Southern Poverty Law Center and ADL and others as hate. I mean, this is just a mild-mannered state, statesman talking about issues. They are really getting ready to go after free speech. What's your take on that? I mean, even if I disagree with a lot of what Limbaugh says, we've got to stand for his free speech, because if they can bring him down, they're openly saying this is going to be a new reign of terror to kick people off of radio and TV. I think they killed Breitbart. He had stuff that was going to destroy Obama. Anybody that tries to bring down Obama is in deep trouble.
Yeah, that's true. But you have to have the guts to do it. Then you take a case like Limbaugh. Well, people like me, we know what Limbaugh is. But we also know that if they can use him as a target for persecution of this type that's being done, then we all lose our freedom. And so therefore, you let the guys who've got the kooky ideas and so forth, let them speak and get the truth out instead. I'm concerned about getting across the truth about what will save this nation. And I'm not that much concerned about people a little bit funny. It's what's needed. For example, we need Glass-Steagall now, and you will never get it unless Obama's removed. Otherwise, it's a popular conception. We need other things. We need to go to a credit system in order to look. For example, we got one of the greatest water crisis the United States has ever experienced, and it hits most of these lands from the Pacific toward the west. Now, we've got a project called NWAPA. It would take 30 years to complete it by the original design. It's been redesigned for modern conditions now and other things. This program, even when it begins to be developed, will be a restoration of the management of our water system and would be the restoration of our ability to grow crops.
That's right. The British system admits they're destroying our entire dam infrastructure, everything. And people shouldn't forget, you are credited with the original brainchild idea, which they took from you. But it's on record that Reagan read your reports, and that's where he got the idea. I mean, that's in the Washington Post. You had the brainchild of Star Wars, but not as an offensive system, as a way to share and then end war, because it was it cut nuclear weapons out of the equation.
That's right, because we can do it again today. We still have this thing. We have problems in the solar system, which are very dangerous for us over the coming period. We have the beginnings of the technology needed to overcome many of these problems. For example, we could be hit by a giant rock of a certain size. They're coming by us all the time. If one of them clobbered us in the vicinity of the North Pole, everybody in this planet, this nation, would be dead. But we have the means, the technologies now, which we can put to work, which will enable us to prevent such things from happening.
Wow, Lennon LaRouche, I know you're a busy man, but maybe you can come back in just a few weeks just on Star Wars, just on a global defense system against these heavenly bodies coming in. Thank you so much for the time. I really appreciate it.
couldn't stop you.
All right, amazing interview. Lyndon LaRouche right there. LaRouchePack.com. I'm Alex Jones with InfoWars.com. Kurt Nemo coming up.
You are listening to GCN. Visit GCNLive.com today.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full-acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for survivalseedbank.com.
Waging war on corruption. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
All right, for the next 30 minutes, riding the shotgun with me is the one, the only editor of InfoWars.com, Kurt Nemo. We're going to intersperse attacks on free speech, how the government is using hacker groups as a pretext to shut down freedom on the web in the name of protecting it. We got to take the freedom away to protect it because of the Stuxnet, which the government launched. That's coming up. And we're also going to get into Nicolas Sarkozy saying, go to hate sites, we're going to arrest you. And then this whole thing is a stage deal. We'll cover more of that after the break. But I wanted to talk to you first about Rush Limbaugh, Kurt. Rush Limbaugh made some mild statements compared to what Robert De Niro said about Mitt Romney's wife and others. Racist comments. He's making the joke about a woman who wants thousands of dollars in condoms and saying, man, you're a, such and such. And whether that's untasteful or not, I wouldn't say something like that. That's his free speech. Media Matters, whose memos got leaked, as you know, a year ago, said we're going to infiltrate media, alternative media, Fox, Rush, you name it, and destroy them from within. That's espionage. That's criminal sabotage. And it's George Soros financing it. And I'm on their radar. And I've always said this when Glenn Beck's behind the scenes doing stuff to us and other things. I said, look, guys, you better watch out because the globalists are going to blow stuff up and blame it on us. And then the memos came out where these White House advisors said, have an Oklahoma, blame it on the libertarian right wing. And people say, well, don't defend Limbaugh. He's not a real patriot. Whatever, the globalists see him in the same box. They're coming after us all. It's like Breitbart. There was evidence of him killing him. He was going after Obama. Doesn't mean I agree with all he's doing. There's evidence of him killing him. The point is the system is now ready to get rid of the fake right that they've been playing patty cake with. Things are moving fast, as you heard Lyndon LaRouche say, who you could call a classic American liberal system. He's certainly not a Republican. Now, we're about to go to break here, but Kurt, your view on them openly saying they want to destroy Rush Limbaugh. I mean, this is so authoritarian.
Well, they obviously set him up to come after us or come after the alternative media. I mean, he doesn't pose a threat to the system. He's absolutely right in their ballpark, actually, when it comes down to it, part of the false right-left paradigm.
But if they can take him down?
They can take him down. They can set a precedent to go after anybody they want to.
And notice Sarkozy saying arrest people that visit sites they don't like.
Well, Sarkozy, I mean, France is a totally different deal. They don't have a Bill of Rights and a Constitution like we do. That's an interesting thing. The whole thing with what's going on in France is very interesting. They're now saying this guy they killed, the supposed terrorist, is a lone wolf.
Which, it's always the lone wolf, always goes to a training camp, always protected, always known, and then dies. Yesterday, I said over and over again, I said, watch him die. In fact, I even said before he was in the apartment, I said, watch him die in a fake apartment blast.
Right.
And they did the same thing in Spain, Kurt?
Yes, absolutely. With the Barcelona stuff, yeah.
We need to do a report.
Madrid stuff.
Yeah, it was Madrid. We need to do a flashback on that.
Yes.
Now, the main reason I wanted to get you to pop in today, and we'll cover it when we come back from break, but start getting into this. Problem, reaction, solution. Anonymous promises to take down the internet, but you've gone and confirmed these are actually government operatives.
Well, we saw when the FBI supposedly busted Sabu, which was his name for the supposed leader of LULUCEC, that he was an FBI informant. He's an operative. And he was giving orders to his fellows there to engage in this behavior.
And that came out in court documents, but they still burn their minions, though.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
It does not pay to work for these guys.
No. You end up dead or in prison.
I mean, why would, even if you were immoral, why would you want to work with a group that almost always burns its minions?
Well, obviously the FBI gave him what he wanted. You know, he's, you know, his ego and whatnot, and maybe money, who knows? And he's in a power position.
And you notice they always order these attacks through these groups right when they want to pass some legislation. It's like clockwork.
Yep, absolutely.
And now they're going to take the internet down. So now all of you good people that got onto the bandwagon in the name of Anonymous, now it's going to be associated with taking the web down.
As a matter of fact, Napolitano was at a conference today talking about cybersecurity. So, and when was that FBI thing? It was last week.
Well, they're trying to pass that to have the Pentagon totally take it over, which they've already done. They just want to announce it. Let's cover this in more detail straight ahead.
You've heard Alex explain how the Silver Lungs generator infuses the respiratory system with your self-produced colloidal silver solutions. Yet many are unaware of the entire function of the silver lung system and how it has been designed to deliver your silver solutions anywhere in or on the body. My name is Mario Cifaldi, and I'm the developer of the Silver Lungs Generator. Not only does the silver lung system produce endless colloidal and ionic silver solutions, it also comes equipped with the proper applicators and devices needed to deliver your silver solutions directly to key target areas. This includes the eyes, ears, nose, lungs, topically to the skin, and orally for the digestive system. Be sure to watch our new 7-minute video tour of the Silver Lung System at www.silverlungs.com to learn more about how the Silver Lung System works. As well, we are always ready to answer any questions you may have. That's www.silverlungs.com.
Folks, Iran and the Mideast nuclear mess is already ballooning our gas prices. Whether you're struggling with food costs, which are being blown up by gas costs now, or know that when the Mideast showdown explodes, whatever food supply you have is all you'll get because of huge panic demand, eFoods Direct Family Packs are the answer. Now, the most affordable, best food is saving you up to 50% compared to other poor quality food companies. The new Alex Jones Quick Fix Family Packs save you so much money, the savings from eating this food will actually help you pay your other bills. No matter what effect the Mideast crisis or the crashing economy have, you'll have food as delicious tonight as 25 years from now. Order now for 50% savings and free shipping on these affordable family packs. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex. Call 800-409-5633 or efoodsdirect.com/Alex.
I had tried everything. I'd cut back the amount of food I was eating. I was lifting weights and jogging, but nothing was working. My body was literally starving for minerals and trace elements as well as key vitamins. And as soon as I had that, I immediately could eat half of what I was eating previously and be satisfied. Now, there are hundreds of great products at InfoWarsTeam.com, but I want to point out the three that have helped me lose 37 pounds in just 2 months. Products like Beyond Tangy Tangerine, Pollen Burst, and Rebound. When I started taking the Tangy Tangerine and other products every day, I lost more than 37 pounds in just 2 months. Now that's results. I want to challenge my listeners to go to InfoWarsTeam.com and to order just 3 of their products, and you will see the changes in the way you look, feel, and in your appetite almost immediately. Start your journey to health and wellness today. InfoWarsTeam.com.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
You know, I just got an idea, and I don't care if it draws down the ire and attacks of the globalist. Ted Anderson advertised some of my DVDs on Rush Limbaugh before, and the ad campaign barely paid for itself. But the mission was to get the films out. and I know his advertising is going to be a lot cheaper now that this happened. I'm going to advertise on Rush Limbaugh. Not my show, because they won't want that. I'm going to advertise a book, a film, whatever. I'm going to do a big advertising buy on Rush Limbaugh. And then we'll educate his kind of neocon, addled audience. And so it's a win-win-win. But I'm not going to let Media Matters do this. And I know we've got some big people out there listening. In fact, I may even tell some of my sponsors they should go advertise over there. Because, I mean, we've got to keep him on air now that George Soros and the globalists are openly trying to shut him down. Because they're bragging that they want to shut down all the libertarian conservative radio and web freedom. I mean, they're saying that's their mission. And even if I totally disagree with Limbaugh, I mean, he could be Keith Olbermann if they were trying to get him off. The only time I say take somebody off air is if they're saying take my liberties. If Limbaugh said, ban my guns and trying to take my it's when people try to take your freedom, that's when they're the enemy. When they've got a view about some larger general issue, my point is boycotts are fine, but when you look at it not being a real grassroots group but George Soros, I mean, this is despicable.
Well, didn't they just, it was yesterday they introduced a bill in California that's related to Limbaugh, didn't they?
Oh yeah, they're people
speech bill or something.
They're talking about making it criminal, right. I mean, that's what they want,
right?
That's what they want. I mean, I've had these groups, because everybody knows I don't cover racial stuff on my show, and I'm for everybody. I actually get criticized by some because they get mad at the whole multicultural deal, and they go, Alex, you know, that's really a racist move. And I'm like, I know, but I'm trying to get everybody to have freedom here. I've had groups go and do this before and try to manufacture what I've said. And I've had to get on the phone with affiliates and say, have you heard it? I mean, they'll take anything and turn it into something. They're out there after us, too. I mean, I'm on Media Matters every week. Limbaugh's on there every day. I mean, George, and they pose as a nonpartisan group, and it's come out, Kurt, they're run by the White House.
Well, will this eventually go to the Supreme
Court? Let me say that again. The White House is trying to kick Rush Limbaugh off the air. That's why I'm against it. Go ahead.
But this will go to the Supreme Court, obviously. But in the meantime, what it'll do would be a chilling effect on Clear Channel.
Well, it's not going to chill me, I'll tell you right now. And let me tell Clear Channel and local radio stations that I know carry a show that aren't Clear Channel owned, and I've told program directors. Because they're like, man, this is scary. They're even coming after us. I go, you better stand up against this to these thugs trying to destroy our First Amendment. I'm serious. I mean, people are like, some radio insiders are like, hey, Alex, more stations are going to dump Limbaugh and put you on. I'm like, I don't want that. I'm on up against Limbaugh. I found out that Huckabee's kind of pleased, and they're advertising to try to get people to throw him off and put Huckabee on. That's despicable. Huckabee, who said he likes Obama and he's a good Christian man a month or two ago. He knows which way it's going. He's saying, give me Limbaugh's spot. I love Obama. I love Obama. Give me Limbaugh's spot.
What was Limbaugh's take? I don't listen to Limbaugh, so I don't know, but what was his take on Romney? Was he a for or against Romney?
He was back and forth, but he kind of liked Gingrich.
Yeah, right.
Hey, but here's my issue. I know I made you come in today to talk about your story, and it's kind of like you're a good Ed McMahon. You just kind of add little points. But I might have you in here full-time, Kurt. How would you like to be a co-host
all
now?
All right.
Tell us about your big report. It's important.
Well, today I wrote a report on LewSec and Anonymous. Anonymous is threatening to take down the Internet on March 31st. By attacking the DNS servers, which are the domain names.
But the Pentagon has a bill to take that over right now. They'll keep it safe.
Right.
Oh.
Absolutely.
Oh.
But the whole point is these groups are ridiculous. They are supposedly political, but they don't do anything that's really political. They're a joke. I mean, the very name LewSec is a take on LOL, Laughing Out Loud. Laughing Out Loud Security is the actual name of the group. What does that mean? It doesn't mean anything. So politically, they're nothing. They're non-starters.
Well, they do this stuff. They say they try to brand hacking as it's just fun to wreck things to laugh, you know, to get the LUTs or whatever.
Right.
But the truth is that's government trying to take it over and make hacking look bad. So they call it Anonymous. Anonymous does some good stuff. It's just random people. And then they demonize it with their own operatives who you've proven are FBI.
Right. I think they have a lot of useful idiots working for them, too, that actually believe this is some kind of political thing or the fun aspect you're talking about.
Yeah.
But it's not. It's a total, I think it's total, you know, psyop just to demonize hackers.
Well, your report goes over that. What do you make of Petraeus saying, yeah, we're using all your appliances to watch you?
That's scary. Yeah, that was that Wired report that came out earlier in the week.
Yeah, I mean, he gave a speech and bragged, and people thought it was a joke, kind of like when the big bioethicist group said, let's start killing little kids even though they're healthy. Everybody's like, that's a joke, right? And they're like, no, we're going to kill them. But then I'm bad for reporting it, Kurt.
Right. Well, this whole thing, they want to put this so-called smart technology in everything, washing machines, televisions, the whole nine yards. It's just part of the surveillance grid.
And then the data goes over your power line, so there's no hooking it up to a connection. Right. Isn't that great? By the way, I want to do a report on all this smart technology. I've begged Watson, because people think I'm joking about the government with grants. When police departments get Homeland Security grants, they go, yeah, here's this smart light bulb. By the way, here's a grant for computers. And the light bulb flickers and interfaces with a sensor and programs the computer remotely.
Right.
And when I say that, people think I'm joking. It's been in the Associated Press, but no one believes it.
Yep. And these drone projects they're giving police departments, they're all financed by the Department of Homeland Security. It's just a total integration of the federal government and the local police.
And then it's a hidden tax. When you pay for a smartphone or you pay for a dishwasher, it's getting where you can't even buy the old ones that don't have the tech in them. So it breaks. There's going to be a big business in keeping the old stuff running. Or they have regulations now. Oh, can't have that. Right. Places can't fix it. I mean, this is Agenda 21. You pay in the cost of the item for all the back doors. And I saw an article in Wired again and one in CNET where all the back doors is why the iPhones and Droids drain so fast. I had a Droid and had to get rid of it because it would decharge an hour because all the spy stuff in the back.
Well, now they're encouraging you to put all your data on their servers. It's iCloud business and stuff.
Yeah, the cloud.
Yeah, so...
So like get in the, it's not really a cloud, it's more like a sewage tank. Get in the sewage tank.
Right.
That doesn't sound so fun. Hey, let's get into your report. I mean, we said it yesterday, false flag. Break down what happened with this Muhammad character over there. I mean, this is the classic earmarks.
Well, there was a report yesterday that he was being followed by French intelligence, which is basically means that he's being handled by, just like Muhammad Atta and the so-called hijackers in Florida were being followed by the federal government and the FBI and the CIA. The same thing was going on in France. He was totally handled by them. And obviously the guy probably did think he was some kind of Al-Qaeda, you know, bigwig going out doing a lone wolf thing for his jihad. But
notice always the same thing, a lone wolf being handled by government informants. We know intelligence was all around him. He thought some of his friends were in French, and you know, were Al-Qaeda, really French intelligence. That's all being confirmed now. He's a lone wolf. Last guy that tries to beat Sarkozy 10 points ahead gets set up by French intelligence with a hooker claiming he raped her. Now it turned out that wasn't true. You've got Le Pen's daughter set to win. Now Sarkozy gets to look like a hero. He's getting a bump in the polls, and he's saying he's going to shut down nationalist sites that are supporting Le Pen.
Right, absolutely. Well, the whole thing is a setup, too. I mean, look, French elections are coming up. Le Pen was growing in the polls, and so they just pulled off a false flag.
And by the way, that's just not us saying that. Here's the Financial Times of London. Sarkozy stands to gain most from what happened. Mm-hmm. And remember, I said he'll be a lone wolf. He would have been trained at a camp or released from a camp. All that's been confirmed. You'll learn that intelligence was following him for years. You'll learn that people warned the police. Turns out that's in the news today.
Right.
Turns out, and he'll die. He'll die. Which, remember what happened in Spain. Remember what happened on the 333. Remember how it came out later. They just blew up some people in an apartment and said that was Al-Qaeda. And it turned out the police had done it.
Right. Right, absolutely.
I mean, that came out in the Spanish news. So it's always the same MO.
Pretty much. Well, of course, they can't have this guy walking around talking and divulging things that are they're going to be used against the government in France. I mean, so obviously he had to die.
Well, I was looking at all the photos of the French cops and watching the news. You got all these regular cop types out there. And you saw the guys in the black mask.
Right, ski mask.
You notice those weren't even special forces typed. I looked at those were criminal eyes. The guys they brought in to blow up whoever was in there, I mean, that's probably the guys that were doing the shooting.
Well, they had our bands that said police on it. So
yeah.
They were with the police.
But, I mean, they looked like something out of Central Casting for gangsters.
Absolutely.
But I'm just saying, you could even see them next to the regular cops. I'm telling you, those weren't even special operations people. They were just criminals.
Right, right. Well, it's interesting. Like I said, the timing, we need to look at the timing. It was right before an election. Why didn't this happen?
We said day one that the Dominique Strauss-Kahn was set up. Turned out, run by Sarkozy. Sarkozy screwed up and announced it before anybody even knew. Yeah. And then it turned out it was that he was under surveillance by Sarkozy.
Right, he wasn't following the script correctly.
Well, I mean, Sarkozy is running a coup against France. He's not even born there. He's a foreign operative.
Yep.
What is it with these foreign operatives?
I don't know, but he's basically on the world government agenda. They're pushing it, him and Merkel in Germany, and Cameron and the whole crew and Obama. They're all just pushing the world government agenda.
Why can't America have an American president, and why can't France have a French president?
Well, obviously, they're trying to tell us something. I mean, they put Obama in there. They can't even verify that he's an American, a naturalized American. They're trying to tell us something. What are they trying to tell us?
Oh, well,
that you know, it doesn't matter. Our Constitution doesn't
matter. That's when he became the head of the UN a few years ago, violating Article 1, Section 9. It is the head of the Security Council. Yeah. Totally illegal. Well, I mean, look at how they have the Pentagon come to Congress and say, you don't run jack squat. You're right. They're just saying that's the way it is. Right. And Petraeus is like, your toaster's watching you. Ha-ha, we don't need warrants anymore. And when Fox News covers it, they're like, he's a great man. We don't know what he means by that. He said there's no more Fourth Amendment. He said we don't consider that violation anymore. Next, they'll shove microphones down our throats and say that we don't consider this a violation of privacy. Courts are ruling with the Seventh Circuit. They can pull you over, grab your phone without a warrant, download it.
Well, timing is everything. It's the same thing with these hacktivist groups. We've got major cybersecurity legislation in Congress right now.
And Anonymous is going to attack.
And so they're running this little sideshow of these so-called hacktivists doing all these funny things to the CIA and Sony and these big corporations. And it's meaningless. And it's just propaganda.
Nemo, you are an incredible person. We'll be right back with the one, the only, Lord Nemo.
You don't need me to tell you that humanity is in a deep crisis. Everyone can feel it. We know a tectonic struggle is now taking place between the forces of freedom and those who love darkness, bondage, and enslavement. Yes, my friends, evil is rising. But take heart. For every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Recently, New World Order operative Hillary Clinton admitted they're losing the info war.
We are in an information war, and we are losing that war.
The globalists are scared. They've overreached. The future of the info war is in your hands. Join PrisonPlanet.tv. Download the thousands of special video reports, ebooks, and more, and get them out to everyone you know. Continue to spread the word about the broadcast on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and every other globalist propaganda platform. We are going to use their system against them. The info war now goes into high gear.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw-free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Attention, information in this one-minute message could save your life. Don't wait for the next emergency to happen. Act now to be prepared. Now, more than ever, civilians and communities must communicate with family, friends, and neighbors in the event of civil unrest, natural disasters, or other emergencies. That's why there's CivilDispatch.com. CivilDispatch.com is a universal system that can be used for a wide array of urgent notification alerts. Weather emergencies, civil unrest, emergency responders, amber alerts, school or business closings, any need-to-know situation. CivilDispatch.com is an emergency dispatch communication system, allowing anyone to quickly and easily send and instantaneously track emergency email and text alert notifications. CivilDispatch.com gives you the power of enterprise alerting without the enterprise cost. Don't find yourself unprepared. Learn more and become a member at CivilDispatch.com. That's CivilDispatch.com. Civilian Emergency Dispatch System. Peace through preparedness.
Do you know which 37 crucial food items are going to fly off the shelves when the next disaster hits? If you don't, you and your family may be without food and waiting in long food lines after a big disaster strikes. You would be surprised how many people don't have these food items right now. 123survivalplan.com has set up a For Patriots Only video with inside information on the 37 food items that will sell out first when the next disaster strikes. The video on 123survivalplan.com has crucial information you and your family need to prepare for any disaster, natural or man-made. And you won't have to be afraid of going hungry or being sent to a FEMA refugee camp. See the video that over 1 million other smart patriots have already seen in the last 4 months. Prepared now. Go to 123survivalplan.com and learn which 37 food items you should hoard. Easy to remember, 123survivalplan.com. Again, that's 123survivalplan.com.
For profit, Federal Reserve, and how to expose it, and some other important news. Nemo is hired now, not just in the last many years, 5 years or so, as the editor of Infowars.com. How long have you been here, Kurt?
2007, was it? I don't remember exactly.
Yeah, well, you've been here 4 or 5 years now, but you were also going to double as the Infowars apparel model.
Uh-huh.
There you go, ladies and gentlemen. He was in a black InfoWars t-shirt earlier, and these just came in the mail. We just, you know, got 1,000 or so of these. Hunter Orange on camo, InfoWars.com, don't tread on me. And it goes great with the hunting season ongoing and spreading the word about liberty. And there is Kurt Nemo. Absolutely. And you can see Kurt demonstrating there for you. We have these at cost 100. You are the resistance business cards with the websites on the back. At cost, you get a citizen rule book and two bumper stickers for $4.95. That is probably really less than cost, but that's what it cost us, and you can get that and spread the word. Da, 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 da. We like need some elevator music in the background. And next, we have even more. Look, Nemo, over here, DVDs. And, all right. Oh, man. Oh, man. Folks, this is my weird mind of humor, is that they ran in with the T-shirts, and Kurt's office is right next door, and I said, Kurt, you love InfoWars shirts. You want this one? You got to model it for us. And Kurt's like, absolutely. Kurt, what do you like better? The classic black InfoWars, or you like the camo? I'm ready to go deer hunting with you right now. Well, turkey hunting or gobbling out behind my house?
Actually, I prefer the black.
You want to go fishing? Let me tell you, around here in Texas, you dress like that, you walk into like some country place, they're going to fall down and start worshiping around on the spot. But try to talk, try to go, how you doing there, boy?
Hey, son, what's up? Let's go fishing, Lake Travis.
Oh, man. We've had so many heavy things here today, and this is what goes on actually here at the office. Whenever I want to be energized by pure power, I just look around the corner because whose office is right next door? Oh, man.
Oh, boy.
Nemo, am I joking?
Yes, you are, Alex.
No, I'm not.
No, he's serious. He's totally serious, folks.
Anyways, well, what do you think of the new camo shirt available at InfoWars.com?
It's nice. I don't prefer camo, but I'm sure a lot of listeners will love it.
I like it.
I prefer the black.
I like black, too. Seriously, we got a bunch of great T-shirts and stuff available at InfoWars.com. And I tend to never plug that. We've got Bloodlines Illuminati back in print because we printed them. I helped Fritz Springmar get that done. We got a bunch of new T-shirts and a bunch of new baseball caps. But quite frankly, what I'm really excited about is the 100 business cards at cost. And by the way, if you try to print 100 business cards, you couldn't get them for this because we bought like a couple hundred thousand or something. So the price was driven down to almost nothing. And then you get the two bumper stickers and the citizen rule book with it, $4.95, and that does just pay for the citizen rule book and the shipping and the cards and all the rest of it. You can also call toll-free, 888-253-3139. So crass commercial plug here in this short segment. Kurt, what do you make of all the other news? What else is on your radar screen right now?
Oh, gosh, there's so much stuff. You know, I mean, it's just like you have to pick and choose what's important, but it's just there's just everything. Everything from the election to Rush Limbaugh's First Amendment right to this terrorist situation in Europe, and it's just across the board.
What do you think largemouth bass are going to be biting on this spring?
some kind of bait. I don't know what. Maybe InfoWars.
Maybe a purple worm with an orange tail, a little bit of glitter.
Right. Same color as this right here.
Exactly. I just feel like I should ask you fishing advice.
You're asking the wrong person.
Chicken livers? What are we trying to catch? Catfish? No, I'm not going and catching catfish. Actually, I don't have time to go fishing.
Exactly.
Kurt, I don't know what it is. Whenever I get you on air, I descend into goofiness. Because I'm intimidated by...
Yeah, right, right.
I am. Hey, InfoWars, kicking some hind end, huh?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
What do you make of what they've done to Ron Paul?
Well, they just totally ignored him, and they were pretty successful in just pretty much ignoring him out of existence. At this point, he's got some delegates. He'll go to the convention, and we'll see what happens from there. But standard MO.
Yeah, he said on Jay Leno he wants to be like a conscience at the convention and try to inject something. So I guess that is the deal. They might let him speak or something, I guess. I hope he doesn't lean over and kiss the holy ring of Lord Romney.
Oh, God. No, I don't think he'll do that. He's got too much...
Yeah, I don't think that's going to happen either.
Too much principle. He's not going to do that.
I wonder if any of his campaign minions, though, will, like, flutter off and join the Romney.
I don't think so. The Ron Paul campaign is very philosophical and very dedicated to Ron Paul.
Hey, they did a great job educating people, and it's still ongoing.
Absolutely, and that's what it's good for, is educating people about that.
And I said that day one, folks, we win by resisting. Everybody knows about the Federal Reserve. Thanks, Kurt.
We're on the march. The Empire's on the run. Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network. When you're out on the road, the last place you want to be is on the road. But if the unfortunate happens, you'll be glad you were wearing diamond gussets.
There's a place down in Tennessee where they make blue diamond gusset jeans. They sew pride in every stitch. Guarantee you love the way they fit. They put a diamond gusset in the crotch where you need it most. Blue diamond gusset's got it. Others don't.
We turn jeans inside out. Diamond gusset jeans. Made in the USA with unparalleled quality. Our Defender motorcycle jeans combine gusset comfort with Kevlar protection, so you can ride all day with confidence. Order yours at gusset.com. Diamond gusset jeans got it. Others don't.
Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones. I'm looking for people that have the wisdom to spot savings, opportunity, and recognize risk. Saving means to make money. The Calbin Pure Soap Company can save you thousands of dollars and give you good old-fashioned real soaps that are triple concentrated and twice as good as what you're using now. Soaps made from vegetable and coconut oils that contain no useless dyes, perfumes, deodorants, or antibacterials. Your risk is the hundreds of hazardous toxic detergents that give you rashes, itching sores, and deteriorating clothing called lint. If you want something better, if you want something you've never had before, you have to do something you've never done before. Getting a free catalog is easy by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. Take charge of your health now by calling 800-340-7091 or see Calbin on the web at 5starsoap.com. A little over a year ago, I began to do a lot of research into why, even though I had a pretty good-sized meal, that I was still starving. And my research led me to a well-known fact that most of the soils that we grow our crops on here in the United States and across the industrialized world are almost completely depleted of almost all of the key minerals and trace elements that our bodies need to rebuild themselves, fight off cancer, and be healthy. I then searched out the best vitamin and mineral company out there and discovered Youngevity. The Youngevity products are designed to give you the real nutrition you need, and once you've got that, you don't have to eat as much to be satisfied. I've lost 37 pounds in 2 months simply getting the vitamins and minerals I need. Check it out for yourself. It's incredible. Go to InfoWarsTeam.com today and order your first canister of Beyond Tangy Tangerine Complete Multivitamin Mineral Complex Dietary Supplement. That's InfoWarsTeam.com.
The answer to 1984 is 1776. You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
We're going to be talking to the author of Dishonest Money, Financing the Road to Ruin. Excellent book that we're carrying at InfoWars.com. It's a quick read. It's only, what, 170-something pages long, but very well documented. So good that G. Edward Griffin endorsed it. An excellent job of condensing the large, complicated topic. G. Edward Griffin, George Shepard, Republic Magazine, called it Understanding the Federal Reserve System Has Never Been Easier, a Must Read. This is great for people that know about the Fed, you know, to go back over the facts of it, but it's really good for people that don't know anything about it, you know, people that want to understand. Get a copy at InfoWars.com and support the author, Joe Plummer, and, of course, us right here at InfoWars. That's how we finance ourselves, is the books, T-shirts, videos, and everything we promote is about either empowering yourself or spreading the word. So it's a win-win-win. Speaking of that, there are a lot of gravity fed filters out there. And over the years, I have bought a lot of them and stored them and also use them in my operation and at home. And when I'm on the road, we've got a ProPure on the road model, which is just amazing because the water goes through it quicker because the gravity fed filter is much bigger. It has colloidal silver impregnated in it. It's just the top of the line. It's the best there is. It's better than anything else I've ever used. And it's got the best fluoride filters. It's got it all. InfoWars.com. And we're running a special that we're starting today because it's already discounted to lower than anybody else has got the ProPure systems. 10% off when you enter the promo code WATER at InfoWars.com. In fact, we can show people watching on PrisonPlanet.tv the entire website. We can just show them the entire shopping cart here. That way we're not just showing them the side there. We can just show them the entire shopping cart. You just go to InfoWars.com and you click on the little shop icon and you can go right there and do that. But this is what I use for my family. And it's the best system out there, and we're giving you 10% off when you enter the product code WATER. Or if you call the office and say that you want the WATER special with the word WATER, you'll get 10% off. But we'll see how long we can do this because, quite frankly, they've been having trouble keeping them in supply. They just manufactured a bunch of new ones. They've been selling out. These are so popular. Because when you compare the stainless steel, the filters, everything to the other leading brands, and we have a breakdown, by the way, to the leading competitor. It just, there's no comparison, and that's all at InfoWars.com there on the water page as well in the preparedness area. Now, some of the other news that I've got here. Israel says threat of strike on Iran is working and that the threat of military strike on Iran is preventing the Islamic Republic from taking the final steps towards developing a nuclear bomb. Well, then please don't attack them. There are reports here of oil prices at $200 a barrel. Analysts are saying that's what's coming. That's CNBC. Boy, if that happens, wasn't Lindsey Williams right? Also, threat of refinery strike could push gas prices higher. Also, CNBC. And we have another report here. They've killed it in the State House in Illinois, a bill saying you can't arrest people from filming police. Well, it's First Amendment. How do the cops film you? It just shows, man, especially in Illinois. Now we have police officers in Illinois that call and stuff. And they're not all bad, but the system is bad. I mean, that is a tyrannical government right there. But what is at the head of this tyrannical government? We tend to get so close to the problem, and we know it's the private Federal Reserve, the big six banks that own it, the same system in Europe. That's the problem. The top of the food chain is Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan, Bank of America, Wells Fargo, Citibank. Bank of England to a certain extent, and all their subsidiaries. They're the ones that have the power to create the money for themselves. They're the ones that want to get us into debt. If you've got unlimited money, how do you get property? Getting people into debt, shutting off the regular economy so you're the only one with money. They're the problem. And we get so close to it, we know that. We forget others don't. People finally know the Federal Reserve is private. And Bernanke's having to send out bureaucrats everywhere to tell and hiring famous people to be pitchmen for the Federal Reserve. They're in trouble. Once you start identifying the power structure instead of the puppets, it's game over. And that's why I'm promoting and selling the book, Dishonest Money, Financing the Road to Ruin, Joseph Plummer, available at InfoWars.com. And it's an excellent book. Joe, how did you awaken to this? And you know, describe as you do in the book exactly what dishonest money means and how if you don't get back to honest money, nothing is ever going to get fixed in this country. Striking at the root with dishonest money. Joseph Plummer, thanks for joining us.
Great to be with you, Alex, and it's really nice to be able to thank you personally for all the great work you've been doing over the past nearly 20 years now. As far as how I first heard about the Federal Reserve System, that was probably an organization called Give Me Liberty, I believe. Bob Schultz, I think, is when I first even heard the term Federal Reserve. And
it just shows how it's a chain reaction. So the last 10 years, and now here you are writing a popular book. It just shows how we can all do something.
Exactly. I had never heard of it, of course, because you certainly don't hear about it much in the mainstream media, and you certainly don't hear about it much in the indoctrination centers. So what is this Federal Reserve? What's so bad about it? And when I first started digging into it, I realized that everything that was available was just needlessly convoluted. I started to suspect that it was intentionally being made more complicated than it needed to be. And so after literally years and years and years of research, you finally start to unearth basically what it is. And I think that the best way to frame it is to think of our current monetary system as literally a weapon of war. That's exactly what it is, because if people think of warfare, they know warfare is meant to weaken the target, but they think generally in terms of tanks and bullets and guns and things like that. They don't think of other forms of warfare that accomplish the exact same thing, and often in a way that's much better, because you can't hide the aggression of tanks and bullets and guns. But, for instance, psychological warfare is very effective at weakening targets, but people may or not be aware of the fact that they're being subjected to psychological warfare. Economic warfare is something that these people have perfected, and they have weakened nation after nation using the current monetary system, this current fraudulent monetary system, which you know so much about because you cover it. But unfortunately, other people don't even know what the term monetary system means, and they certainly don't understand that there are different kinds of money, some which are completely dishonest. To basically summarize dishonest money, unearned money, unearned fraudulent money, not money in the sense that you think of money, like you have to provide a product or service if you want money, and other people do too. They simply create the money out of thin air. And then worse than the power that would go with being able to simply create money out of thin air and spend it into existence, they could buy up whatever they wanted. Worse than that, they loan it into existence. So they create this inescapable crushing debt, and with that, they of course they expand their power and gain control. And the goal is, as you already know, to establish a one-world monetary system and use that to create their global technocracy utopia. How's that for a mouthful?
No, I'm just sitting back listening here. Go over why it's important for people to read this book. Even if you think you know about the Federal Reserve, it's good to really refresh yourself on it, to really understand this is the problem, this is the enemy, this is where all the globalist power comes from, not just here but worldwide. And then it's important to warn others. Or they're going to think, oh, it's that darn Obama, or it's that darn, you know, Bush or Romney or whoever, instead of, hey, that's just rearranging chairs on the Titanic.
Exactly. I'll go back to the warfare analogy. What do you do when you're engaged in war? What is one of the first things that you want to do? You want to cut the supply lines. And this is the supply line. This is the inexhaustible source of financing. Any organization or individual, if they want to do something, has to have the money to do it. And there are limits to how much money the government can take through taxation. So this provides a covert means for financing. It's still taxation. It's still the exact same thing. If you have $10,000 and the government takes $3,000 of your money, it's reduced your purchasing power by 30%. But the same thing happens if you have $10,000 and the government, through an inflationary policy, reduces the purchasing power of your money by 30%. It's the same thing. The only difference is most people are unaware of what's going on or what's happening. They can't quite put their finger on it. And this really is the root of our problem. All of these things that the government is doing, and again, you've done such an excellent job of covering these things, from injecting pregnant women with plutonium and just every horribly corrupt overtly criminal thing that the government engages in, it has to have money to do these things. And the Federal Reserve System is supplying these people this endless supply of money at our expense, and they don't care what the money is for, because ultimately, in the end, it's about weakening national sovereignty, creating enormous debt, weakening national sovereignty, and then eventually, once that's been achieved, when they finally do destroy the dollar and bring the United States to its knees financially, they will be able to sell this, you know, one world currency, one world global system that they've been working on for 100 years now.
Well, you're right. Now, Joe, there's other ways they engage in this as well. And one of the big ones is they'll give their own private banks the money at 0% interest and then loan it back to us. Or worse, they'll create all these other financial derivatives, financial counterfeits, outside of the fractional reserve banking system they control, where for every dollar they have in there, they loan out 10 or more. They then threaten to bring down the whole system because they've created fraud, have the media they own never report that, hold everyone hostage, and then get bailed out. But because we bail them out, we're then in debt to them. So yeah, it's just so over the top ridiculous that people can't seem to get it, because it's so ridiculous.
It's pretty brazen and sophisticated. And I guess if you want to call it this, I don't really consider it genius, but it's a very ingenious system for transferring wealth and power away from the people who have rightfully earned it into the pockets of the people who have created this predatory
system. That's right. And it's worse than that. In fact, the guys can just search engine this. Just search engine. Ben Bernanke says raise taxes, or European Central Bank says raise taxes. They're always saying raise taxes because they get the money in bailouts and funding. They run the government. That's why they have Warren Buffett, who's basically exempt from taxes, going, oh, I don't pay much. And then his plan is raise middle class taxes, not his own. I mean, it's these rich pigs ripping us off, running the government. They're not capitalist. And they blame capitalism for what they've done when it's just insider fraud. And then they want to tax me and my neighbors, and blue collar workers are having their taxes raised. I mean, it's so diabolical. It's so parasitic. It's so ridiculous. And I want the con to end. It's so obvious. If we can just educate people, it's over. And as Zbigniew Brzezinski said last year, and again in his new book that came out 2 months ago, I refused to buy it, but at the bookstore I did go to the first chapter. It's on that. He wrote 5 points that face the global elite. And the first one is that the people are waking up to us, not our puppets. So Hillary said they're losing the info war. So I'm telling you, folks, this is coffin nails. This is a stake in the vampire's heart. But we're going to have to use it on them. You know, that's why your book is so important. And a lot of these books on the Federal Reserve are 500 pages long and very technical. And I don't want to say yours is. Yours is very well written, and it's technical as well, but it's simple. It's simple. And that's why I also promote American Dream, that we sell at a very low price at InfoWars.com. Because it's a 30-minute film, cartoon style, that anybody will watch about the Federal Reserve. I think this complements it very, very well.
Well, I appreciate that. That was the whole point of writing this book, is that I just could not find anything. It wasn't like I really wanted to tackle this topic. It's a really ugly, dry topic, but I tried the best I could to make it as entertaining and simple to understand as I could. And based on the feedback to this point, it's received good feedback from people who understand it, and most importantly, from the people who had no idea how it operates, yeah, how the system's being used against them. That was really the target audience. But again, people who do understand it, it's good. You know, I lay out all these examples of how they're transferring the wealth, how they benefit from the system.
Now, you've got it all in there. But let me just add this. I should have said, too, you've had a lot of really successful things you were doing that you gave up to do this. Joe Plummer is an entrepreneur, civic-minded writer in 98. He published StopDrinking.com, now located at HowToStopDrinking.org, to counter the commonly accepted disease theory of alcohol and drug addiction. In 2003, he sold his successful consumer watchdog site, FairBet.org, I remember that site, and began focusing full-time on corruption in government. In 2004, he published StopTheLie.com, to expose government abuse and propaganda in 2009. After 6 years of research, he published Dishonest Money, Financing the Road to Ruin. Dishonest Money explains how the elite are using our fraudulent monetary system to weaken the United States and usher in an unelected, unaccountable world government. The book has received great reviews. And again, this is it. It's either us or them. It's not just like we have foreign con artist bankers that took over. They happen to be eugenicists on top of it. They happen to be really nasty, and they've taken the world over by fraud, and now they don't want us here. I mean, you find out they're the ones financing the anti-family, the garbage in the vaccines, the UN, the land grabs. It's them. They're the bad guys. They're the bad guys. What did you think of this big Goldman Sachs exec quitting and saying, we're trying to hurt our customers, we call them scum, we call them Muppets, this is a criminal group?
It's good. You know, it's interesting that you brought up all that other stuff, because I'm covering all that in my next book. The eugenicist angle and a lot of other things. And I'm going a step further. With Dishonest Money, I try to take what is a fairly intimidating topic to most people and really reduce it to the most simple form. And when you do that, it really isn't that complicated. So I want to encourage people, please, if nothing else, to learn about the Federal Reserve System, because this really is, like I said, this is the funding mechanism that we do not currently control, and we can yell and scream and raise our fists about what they're doing, but until we can cut off the money, they're going to keep doing whatever they want. If they can keep confiscating the money from us via inflation and through, to a lesser degree, even though people don't realize that, through the taxation system, we're going to have real problems. But in the next book, I took the same concept of trying to reach out past the choir, and I wrote this is factual fiction, and we haven't talked about this, but I think you'll like the lead character's name is Alex, and his last name is Watson, and yes, you better believe that's a hat tip to you yourself, and of course Paul, for all the work they've been doing.
Oh, that's exciting! I can't wait to read that. Well, and listen. Good, smart folks like you writing books and doing this, it makes us all safer. We need there to be hundreds of thousands of Alex Joneses and Paul Watsons, and they're there. They're people like Joe Plummer. I mean, you guys are really kicking some hind end. I want to talk a little bit more about some of the new developments in the Federal Reserve and how its sister group is taking over Europe right now with Joe Plummer. The book, Dishonest Money, Financing the Road to Ruin. And I know all the other radio shows listen to my show. Hope you get Joe on, because his book needs to get out there to people. And if you got friends and family that don't get it, this is a great book for people to understand why they're losing their jobs, why money doesn't go as far, why all this is happening. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
Hi, this is Alex Jones. Did you know that the global elite are now storing non-hybrid seeds in secret storage vaults near the Arctic Circle? Did you know that in a real meltdown, non-hybrid seeds can become more valuable than silver or gold? It's true, seeds have outperformed even gold and silver before in this country, and it's possible that could even happen again. So our friends at Solutions from Science have put together the perfect mix of non-hybrid seeds. They call it a survival seed bank, and it can produce an endless supply of nutrient-dense food for you and your family. And here's the best part. These seeds have not been genetically modified in any way, and you actually get enough seeds to plant a full acre crisis garden. So visit them today at survivalseedbank.com. That's survivalseedbank.com, or give them a call at 877-327-0365. That's 877-327-0365. Remember, in a real crisis, non-hybrid seeds are the ultimate barter item. This is Alex Jones for SurvivalSeedBank.com.
Would it save you time to get the best quality water filters and the best quality storable foods from one company? You bet it would, and now you can at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. Big Berkey water filter products and great-tasting, long-lasting, storable Wise foods are both now available on one website, BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. Wise foods, ready-to-eat meals, are packed in airtight nitrogen pouches and come with a 25-year shelf life. Big Berkey water filters are powerful enough to purify treated, untreated, or even stagnant pond water. Combine Berkey water filters with Wise foods for an unbeatable preparedness combination. Get free shipping on every order over $50. And GCN listeners receive 5% off all ceramic filter systems. Visit BigBerkey waterfilters.com or call 877-99-BERKEY. That's 877-99-BERKEY. Or go to BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com.
Do you suffer from low-functioning adrenal or thyroid? Did you know that mercury from your dental fillings comes off of your teeth both as a vapor and as particles into your body? Wherever mercury deposits in your body, it stops cells from functioning normally. Animal studies show that mercury causes kidney function to drop by 60%. Mercury deposited into your adrenals or thyroid will cause a corresponding drop in function. The number one method by which your body detoxifies itself of mercury is glutathione. The number one superfood that helps turn on all 10 trillion cells of your body to produce glutathione is non-denatured whey protein from grass-fed cows. After investigating most high-end whey proteins on the market, only one is the most non-denatured, the most active, the most complete, and in our opinion, the most powerful in what nature originally put into the fresh raw whey. It is One World Whey. Call 888-988-3325. That's 888-988-3325. Or visit oneworldwhey.com. That's oneworldwhey.com.
Shackles. Folks, make no mistake, the system is coming after our free speech. They're going after Limbaugh, whether you love him or hate him. The point is they're trying to target him because they can bring down the big guy. The system sees talk radio as alternative because you can call into it, and it's long form. And the system said they want to shut down talk radio. They've had like 10 different senators the last 3 years say that. We need to understand that's happening. Also, the system wants to gear up new wars. Here's a really creepy article, Associated Press. NYPD says Iran has conducted surveillance in New York City ahead of, quote, staging attacks. Pray that there's not a false flag to get the Iran war going. Wow, if you missed it, that Lyndon LaRouge interview earlier, it'll re-air in the audio streams and on stations that re-air the show, was amazing. All this is going on. Again, the book is Dishonest Money, Financing the Road to Ruin. Joseph Plummer, excellent book to expose how these globalists have done this to us. Because if you don't fix this, you know, they're trying to totally set up an authoritarian system to secure their ill-gotten gains. And they openly say they want to reduce our numbers because they've stolen everything. They don't want us around. These are really nasty people. And again, I just keep going back to that. Other points, Joe, you want to make about the book that you think are important?
I think we've covered most of it. Just basically, I want people to learn how this system is being used against them so that when they create the inevitable crisis that they're trying to create, there will be greater resistance and the ability to, you know, lay the foundation for what will replace what they've created. It's great if people can go out and write books or do documentaries or whatever. You know, all of these things are very useful, but it's the most important thing for people to do is to simply gain an awareness of what's going on, because they cannot operate their scam if people understand what's going on. And it really is, their entire system is based on deception, theft, and violence, and deception really being the primary element that it's all built on. So once people start to understand any scam, it doesn't matter what it is, if it's a phone scam where somebody calls and says, hey, guess what? You just want a brand new Ford F-150. All you need to do is give us your banking information so we can, you know, get the shipping fees and send it to you. People will fall for that until maybe they realize, oh, wow, that's a scam. And then they won't fall for it anymore. As long as everybody's aware of that's a particular scam, they won't fall for it. Same kind of concept with all of these other things that they're doing. The genetically modified food that they're using to poison us with, the fluoride that they're dumping in the water. All of these things, to the extent that people gain awareness of what's actually going on and hear the other side of the story, it weakens them.
Bisphenol A now is being pulled everywhere. Exactly. When we take action, we win. But if we just feel powerless and give up, it's over. Can't wait for your new book to come out, Dishonest Money, Financing the Road to Ruin, available at Infowars.com. Thank you so much for the time today, Joe.
It's great to be with you, Alex. If I say one thing real quick, I hope that people will purchase the book from you. That's because this is how, as you've said, and as you know, all organizations live or die based on financing. So take that power that you're going to take out of your pocket and please and purchase it either through InfoWars directly, or if you have to use Amazon, I know that you guys have it listed on Amazon as well.
Absolutely. Listen, God bless you. We're out of time, my friend. Look forward to having you back up soon because the book's excellent. Another great fighter for liberty. Here's a final article, Scientific American. I didn't even get to this. I see articles like this every day. Effective world government will be needed to stave off climate catastrophe. Now, what did they say in secret world government documents that got leaked? They would use the threat of environmental crises, including weather weapons they have, to scare the public into giving up authority to a private megabank. And it's all here, Scientific American. They're openly pushing world government. So why does the Southern Poverty Law Center say that it doesn't exist and you're an evil terrorist if you talk about world government? Show them the Scientific American pushing it. It's everywhere. It's real. We were right. You were right. Now get out there and redouble.
Thank you for listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Folks, Iran and the Mideast nuclear mess is already ballooning our gas prices. Whether you're struggling with food costs, which are being blown up by gas costs now, or know that when the Mideast showdown explodes, whatever food supply you have,